Just outside of Laramie, the Cowboy State is quiet, peaceful, scenic, just like any other Saturday. But this is a Saturday unlike any other, because the ninth-ranked Nebraska Cornhuskers are in town, and the atmosphere reflects that of a matchup between two unbeatens. Bo Pelini and his Huskers have arrived. He has his sights set on the Cowboys. The Cowboys are out to prove their worth to the nation, to the conference, to the Huskers, and maybe most importantly, to themselves. Nebraska and Wyoming enter this contest with identical 3-0 records. However, Nebraska's perfection was expected, and there are, of course, expectations now that it will continue into October and November. Meanwhile, Wyoming's 3-0 mark, its first since 1996, comes with a major question mark. Are the Cowboys really that good? We know one thing, they are that young at the most important position. This is true freshman quarterback Brett Smith, the Oregon Player of the Year last year, already with victories over Weber State, Texas State, and Bowling Green, but the ante is about to be upped in a major way against the number 9 Cornhuskers. My partner tonight, Sean King, started as a true freshman at Tulane, so you know exactly what he's going through. What advice would you give him right now?
I had everything under control until I ran on the field the first time for our first series. All the emotions, the nervousness, the apprehension, it was overwhelming. Very important early in this game that their offensive coordinator, Greg Brandon, get Brett Smith some easy completions and build his confidence.
And his counterpart tonight, Taylor Martinez, not exactly a veteran, just a sophomore. However, this offense, literally and figuratively, Sean, runs right through him.
Dynamic athlete, elusive in the open field, elite top-end speed, one of the three best athletes playing the quarterback position in all of college football.
Wyoming coaches and veterans been saying all week, just another game, no one game bigger than the other, but they know very well tonight's opportunity is special.
Having a team like Nebraska come into Laramie, a team with so much tradition and success over the years, is a really fun and exciting game.
The game will be a sellout. It certainly has had a huge impact on Cowboy football and the excitement around the state.
It's going to be a fun game. I'm looking forward to it.
Beautiful evening in Laramie, Wyoming, as expected. 32,000, a mix of brown and gold, speckled in with a little bit of red. And here come the Wyoming Cowboys. Dave Christensen, the head coach of Wyoming in his third season. Wyoming has taken on Nebraska 5 times in the history of this program. All 5 of those contests, though, taking place in Lincoln, Nebraska. And the Huskers owning this series, winning those 5 games by a score of 203-69. Wins over Weber State, Texas State, and a big road win at Bowling Green last weekend. As for Nebraska, Tennessee, Chattanooga, Fresno State, and Washington all in the rearview mirror. Nebraska climbing up to number 9. In the polls, and here comes the nation's ninth-ranked team, led by Bo Pelini. The University of Wyoming added over 3,000 seats to match the need for tickets for all the Husker fans to drive west and come to this game. A little over 32,000 inside War Memorial tonight. And what a stretch it's going to be for the Huskers. Beginning with Wyoming tonight, here is our Anthony Heron with the head coach of Nebraska, Bo Pelini.
And Bo, you've got a combination of explosiveness and youth in your lineup. What concerns you about this first road trip?
Well, I just want to see our guys come out and execute the way we're capable of executing. You know, I'm looking for consistency and efficiency from our football team, and I just want to see us make the next step and become a better football team tonight.
And you told us this week how happy you were with the growth of your quarterback, Taylor Martinez. What's the biggest difference from last season?
I think he's really in control. I think his confidence has grown. I've said before, he's a different player than he was a year ago, and he's just so under. I thought last week was the most in command I've ever seen him, and I think the sky's the limit for him.
Thanks a lot. Good luck tonight, Bo. And guys, the word from down here on the field is that All-American candidate defensive tackle Jared Crick will be out for tonight's game. We know he didn't practice throughout the week, not dressed for tonight's contest, so Terrence Moore, his backup, will be starting in his place. I'm looking forward to that defensive front, as ferocious as any in the country, to still get after true freshman QB Brett Smith. He's got to get the ball out of his hands in about 2.5 seconds, I think, so I watch that from down here on field level.
And Anthony, even with the All-American Jared Crick in the lineup, the Nebraska defense hasn't been as good as expected. Over 800 yards given up to Fresno State and Washington. Are they a little bit lesser than you expected them to be?
I don't think so. They're very athletic. They're very talented. But they are inexperienced. They've had some lapses in their run fits. Bo Pelini said they've worked on that pre- and post-practice, and he's excited to see this group play this afternoon.
It is 3-0 Nebraska, making a little bit of a trip west to take on the Wyoming Cowboys here in Laramie. A perfect night. Those blue skies are going to give way to lights. We'll play it under the lights here. It's 3-0, takes on 3-0. Again, Nebraska leading this series 5-0. The first time the Huskers and the Cowboys playing right here in Laramie. A lot of gold, a little more red than maybe you thought. I mean, we were told it was going to be in that end zone there, but I see red all over the stadium.
Nebraska is a program that's rich in tradition. They travel extremely well.
Nebraska won the toss. The Huskers defer, so Wyoming will get the first shot to be on offense. Dave Christensen telling us in his office on Friday, we have constructed a plan that we think works when lining up against a team that, hey, let's be honest, is physically better than we are.
It's a physical mismatch. Nebraska is the more dominant, the more athletic team. But Dave Christensen said it best. Well, his guys are going to play with effort. They're going to play with heart. He feels he has a scheme that will give them an opportunity to pull the upset.
Kicking off for Nebraska will be Brett Maher, who also acts as the punter for these Nebraska Cornhuskers. And deep, the true freshman, number 33, Dominic Rufran, and the running back, Ghali Muhammad. The same Ghali Muhammad who started at linebacker for Wyoming a year ago.
And Maher can really boom it. Hit a 63-yard field goal in warm-ups.
Ghali Muhammad will not get the chance to bring that out. It'll be first and 10 Cowboys from their own 20. Here are this evening's Discover lineups. We first go up front with those Cowboys led by Nick Carlson. He is on the Remington watch list, starting 24 out of 25 career games. It is running back by committee for Dave Christensen's Cowboys. Alvester Alexander gets the start. You'll see plenty of Brandon Miller, number 18, and also Ghali Muhammad, number 23. Right there is a good look at the true freshman quarterback making his fourth career start, Brett Smith. Balance between the run and the pass so far, 52% run and 48 pass through three games for Wyoming. This is Brandon Miller. We do have a penalty flag down as he goes for 3 yards. Tackle made by Levante David. Referee tonight is Dennis Lipsky.
Illegal formation. There were five players in the backfield. That's a 5-yard penalty. We'll repeat. First stop.
Receiver. And this is something we should keep our eye on. Greg Brandon said they have five personnel groups in for tonight's ballgame, which is more than they've used throughout the year. They're going to try and fool this Nebraska defense with their different alignments.
Cowboys to the ground. Baker Steinkuhler there. Levante David there. Loss of two. Husker defense coming up strong early.
And Baker Steinkuhler, you see he's right here. He's going to get great penetration into the Wyoming backfield. And this is something that Wyoming's going to have to deal with all night. That Nebraska front four is a lot bigger, and they're stronger than Wyoming's offensive line. And it's a concern for Greg Brandon and that offense coming into the game. But Dave Christensen made an interesting point. He thought they could run the football right at Nebraska this afternoon. We'll find out.
Levante David, number 4 for Nebraska preseason All-America selection right now, leading the Big Ten in tackles per game with just under 11. Smith going to keep it himself. Gets out between the 18 and the 19. Levante David there one more time. The gain is 5.
And when you watch the defensive tackles from Nebraska work, and this two-gap technique that I'm definitely going to diagram for you a bit throughout the night, that allows the linebackers, that allows a guy like Levante David, like we saw a snap ago, get into the backfield because they eat up the blocks of the offensive line and allow their linebackers to roam.
Third down and 12 now for the true freshman quarterback, Brett Smith. Rolling out to his right and just firing it, avoiding the sack, avoiding a negative play, but the Wyoming Cowboys will go three and out. We were told Wyoming would change the launch point to get away from that pass rush, but Brett Smith couldn't escape it here.
They're going to move the launch point, but this is his outstanding coverage by the Nebraska secondary. P.J. Smith comes into the game at safety when they go to nickel, and their starting safety, Damon Stafford, moves into the box. I thought a good decision by the freshman quarterback, Brett Smith. No one was open. Throw the football away and punt.
Austin McCoy. Kicking off to Amir Abdullah. Doesn't get a chance to return it. Exactly what Wyoming had in mind. A punt of 59. No return. Net of 59. Taylor Martinez, one of the most explosive dual threat quarterbacks in the nation, out to make his 16th career start tonight. We heard the confidence the head coach Bo Pelini has in him prior to the game. He's had the exact same message for us this week. More confidence in him than I've ever had. He's more in command of this offense than I've ever seen it. His first chance tonight comes from the 23-yard line on first and 10. Rex Burkhead, the tailback behind Martinez. Burkhead trying to cut it off the left side. Stiff arm in Zacha. Gets by Bazoons. Finally run out of bounds by Marqueston Huff. A gain of 7.
Rex Burkhead had a career-high 22 carries last week against Washington. He said he likes the extra workload. He really wants to be the workhorse in this backfield. They have some very talented freshmen that we'll see tonight, but Burkhead wants the carries.
Martinez on the play action, looking for the pass. Finds the true freshman, Kenny Bell, for a Nebraska first down and a gain of 9. I guess we can say Tim Beck's group off to a solid start. Gain of 7, gain of 9, first and 10.
And Nebraska's known for running the football, Paul, but they have a group of wide receivers that are extremely athletic and extremely fast.
16 yards already on this drive, bringing up first and 10 on Nebraska's own 42. Rex Burkhead, the lone running back. He is to Taylor Martinez left. Martinez keeps it himself. Gabe Napton takes him for himself for a loss of 3.
And defensive coordinator Marty English, if you watch, they're going to keep a cocoon for Taylor Martinez. They're not as worried about putting pressure up the field as they are with keeping him contained and in the pocket. They feel if they force Taylor to throw the football, that they have a good chance of him making some bad decisions and them forcing some turnovers.
Gabe Napton, the senior from Meade, Colorado, now with 3 sacks on the season. Second down, 13. Cowboys bring 4. Martinez to the air, has Brandon Kinney. Out to the 47-yard line, tackle made by Marqueston Huff. Huskers pick up 9.
Great route by Brandon Kinney. You see him here. He's going to go down and run a little hook route. He was the one receiver coming into this season that had caught passes. A big wide receiver at 6'3", 225. Funny throwing motion by Taylor Martinez, but so far tonight, he's been accurate with the football.
Accuracy has not been his strong point so far this season. Has yet to have a game through 3 games, completing more than 50% of his passes. In fact, coming off back-to-back performances where he went 10 of 21. Cornhuskers call the first time out of the game. They'll face 3rd and 4 when we come back to Laramie. Welcome Welcome back to War Memorial Stadium here in Laramie, Wyoming. Wolbermeister, Sean King in the booth, Anthony Heron on the sideline, and that Nebraska offense facing a third down and four situation on its first drive of the game.
And Paul, I'm going to have my eye on Josh Bazunes. He's the best pass rusher, especially on the edge for Wyoming. They like to free him up in situations like this. He can give a free call to his defensive tackle, and they can cover him on a two-way go.
Martinez working that option. Wanted to pitch, then kept it himself. The Wyoming defense is there. Looked like the football came out. Wyoming did recover. Nebraska did recover. The Wyoming defense holds. Big stop on third and four.
An indecision by Taylor Martinez as he comes down the line. Unsure if he wants to pitch it, if he wants to keep it. When you're running that option attack, ball security always has to be the number one priority for the quarterback.
Back to receive is Trey Norman. Nebraska punter is Brett Maher. With an excellent punt, and the Huskers will down it at the 1 yard line. Kenny Bell, number 80, is the true freshman receiver.
Very smart play by Kenny Bell. You're going to see him come into the screen right here, understanding that you don't want to take the chance of that ball ricocheting into the end zone. Great job by the punter, Maher.
That's Marcus Mendoza, the cornerback, senior out of Houston. Putting it down there at the one. Tough spot for the true freshman quarterback, Brett Smith, on what will be his second possession of the night. Running back behind him is the sophomore from Parker, Colorado, Brandon Miller. Miller right up the middle out to the 3 yard line. Gain of two for the Cowboys. Tackle made by Levante David. Discover starting lineups for the Nebraska defense. All-American Jared Crick not playing this evening. Terrence Moore gets his second career start. In the nickel spot, which is what they started out in, only two linebackers. Levante David leads the Big Ten in tackles per game. Alfonso Dennard, also a preseason All-American, making his first start of the season tied. Strained left quad has kept him out. Miller again just across the 5 yard line for a gain of three. Tackle made by Will Compton.
This Nebraska defense is extremely talented. They've had some issues early in the season with their run fits. Opelini said they spent 20 minutes before and after practice now just walking through where they're supposed to be from an alignment standpoint and where they're supposed to fit on the run.
Third down and five now, knowing you have a true freshman quarterback there, Sean, do you go the conservative route, or this point of the game, that part of the field, do you trust him?
I think you're backed up. I think this is a perfect time to run a draw play. You don't want to have him commit a turnover. Keep it simple.
Huskers bring four. Smith to his right. About 2 yards past Mazi Ogbonna. It'll bring up fourth and five.
And an important note, guys, as far as what we're seeing from Wyoming offensively so far, Dave Christensen told us this is going to be a completely different tempo from the Cowboys this week. They're normally a hurry-up offense, one of those really fast spread looks. So even though they're punting in this situation, no negative loss plays. Their true freshman quarterback is out of harm's way. They've run some time off the clock, and now they're in position to punt it away.
Number 46 providing the pressure was Eric Martin, that is Austin McCoy. Amir Abdullah with the fair catch at the 45-yard line. Punt of 39 yards. We are scoreless in Laramie, and the Nebraska Cornhuskers with the football when we come back. Unbeaten Nebraska and unbeaten Wyoming, scoreless. 8:38 left in the first quarter. Nebraska getting started on its second possession. Taylor Martinez so far, 2 for 2, 21 yards through the air, 2 rushes. For negative two. This is Rex Burkhead cutting it up, finding wide open spaces. Off to the races down the left side. Rex Burkhead, touchdown, Cornhuskers.
One of the ways that Wyoming wanted to defend the run, if you see the corner comes into the screen right there, was by having the corners forced. If they're going to do that, that is an all-day job to ask Tashawn Gibson and Marqueston Huff to tackle Rex Burkhead in the open field. And you see what happens right there. If that corner misses, the running back's out the gate.
Number 96, Brett Maher, up and in, remains perfect on the season. 17 for 17 extra points. Also 7 for 7 field goals, and Nebraska leads 7-0. Rex Burkhead, when we met with him yesterday, Sean, I thought he was all smiles. This is going to make him even happier.
And this is just outstanding. If you look at the quarterback here, these are the things that you don't see. You come in, you see him come back and steal Corey Jones from coming down the line and making that tackle. Quincy Anunwa down the field, making blocks. This is a very difficult offense to defend.
Look at Tyler Legate just out of your screen, making a big block. Then the wide receiver, as you pointed out, Quincy Anunwa blocking. Nice job to Rex Burkhead, but he had plenty of help there from every level of that offense.
And guys, when we talk about the physical advantage that Nebraska has, it's not just at the line of scrimmage. I just saw Quincy Anunwa downfield blocking. His fullback, Legate, just running to the second and third levels of the Wyoming defense. The physical advantage happens with the smaller positions as well. As much as I hate to admit it, Sean,
even the quarterback got in on them. I wanted to get a sticker for making a block on a touchdown run.
Hey, I think he's expected to make the toss pitch, peel back for a block. Ghali Muhammad watches it sail through the end zone. It'll be 1st and 10, Cowboys from the 20-yard line, trailing 7-0. There is one moment in every game that changes everything. NFL Turning Point, an all-new weekly series produced by NFL Films, beginning Thursday night, 10 Eastern, only on Versus. Wyoming is 3-0, but in all three of their wins this season, the opponent has scored first. Brett Smith been in this spot before, just not against the caliber of opponents that he's seeing tonight.
And Wyoming has to find a way to get a couple first downs. You don't want this to turn into a battle of attrition with your defense. Nebraska's physically more dominant offensively than you are defensively. They've got to find a way to get some first downs.
Dave Christensen sharing with us that he wants to slow this game down, work the running game, take as much time off the clock every series as he can. There's the running game, and there's that Nebraska defense. Although that's a nice pickup for the Wyoming ground game, at gain of 5.
Alvester Alexander with a nice 8-gap run. Very interesting that Greg Brandon and Dave Christensen thought that they could run the ball right at Nebraska.
I'm not sure how much they exactly believe they couldn't. Maybe it seemed like the better option and taking time off the clock. They're trying to put too much on that freshman quarterback. It's now 2nd and 5. Ghali Muhammad, the tailback, to Brett Smith's left. Muhammad dancing his way through the middle. Nebraska defense is there after a gain of 3. Tackle made by Levante David. Little help from Corey Cooper.
And P.J. Smith, he's not in the screen. He's going to come from back here. He's playing safety. Watch how he comes and supports the run. Levante David is in his gap. The safety, you can tell they're paying attention. This was a situation previously that was a huge problem for this defense, where their safety's not supporting correctly in the run. P.J. Smith, where he's supposed to be, makes a good hit.
3rd down and 2. Ghali Muhammad still the tailback to the left of Brett Smith. Smith to the air. Finding the freshman at Josh Doxson, gain of 5, Wyoming 1st down.
And on my individual clock, I'm going to say about a half second, that ball was in Brett Smith's hand before he let it go. And that's where he needs to be at. Let him operate at a comfortable tempo and give him these short, easy, simple pass routes. Nebraska goes into their dime look, brought some late pressure, but that's what you need to do. It talks about the percentage of the offense that they can put in for Wyoming is dependent upon this true freshman quarterback.
And Nebraska that time bringing safety number 3, Damian Stafford, on the blitz was untouched. But as Anthony pointed out, when you get rid of it in less than a second, that blitz is not going to get home. 1st and 10. Brett Smith in trouble. Will Compton lets him go. But Smith not going to get away. Loss of 4. Thad Randall providing the sack.
And if you notice, Taylor Martinez had a fumble earlier in this ball game. Ball security is going to be very important for the young quarterback. If you see, you don't, yeah, I know he's trying to make the defender miss, but you don't want that ball wagging out there because Nebraska will see that. They'll swipe out and it'll cause a turnover.
And Will Compton about as happy as anyone just to be in the lineup. Last season had to miss several games, didn't get in the lineup until almost week six with an injury. And Nebraska in the Big 12 had to go more of a dime package.
Second 13 from the shotgun. Smith rolling out. This is Chris McNeil. Lost his footing. Nice job of staying alive right at the sticks. Tackle made by Corey Cooper. And that will be a Wyoming first down after a gain of 10.
And I think Wyoming can take advantage of this matchup. This is Corey Cooper. He's played safety. They moved him to corner this week. If you can tell, not really fluid with his hips. Maybe something, if you're Greg Brandon, you maybe see an advantage right there from a one-on-one matchup standpoint, something that you can take advantage of as the game continues.
Chris McNeil providing the first down right there. 23 career starts. That's Wyoming's most experienced wide receiver. 13th catch of his young season. This is Alvester Alexander. Out to the 47-yard line, gain of 3. Tackle made by Corey Cooper.
And some of these plays designed as far as whether or not Brett Smith is going to give the ball or keep the ball. Once he grows more in this spread offense, they're going to have more comfort just allowing him to make that decision on the fly, because it's usually a look key when you're going to do that as a quarterback in the spread, as you know, Sean.
Wanted to limit the amount of quarterback runs today. Didn't want Brett to take too many hits. Only have 3 designed for the quarterback to run the football.
Second down 7. Alvester Alexander rerouted, bouncing off to the right side. That Nebraska defense, nice job of adjusting it. No gain. That's Levante David. Get used to hearing his name. And number 34 is Cameron Meredith from his defensive end position.
And Paul Terrence Moore, who's filling in for Jared Crick, which start in most programs. You see that penetration right over the center. Nick Carlson has to do a better job of coming off the football, not allowing Terrence Moore to get into the backfield and disrupt the running play.
Third down and 7. There's Levante David getting the unique advice from his coaches. Don't play so fast. Slow it down. Get under control and be in the right spot. Wyoming has to get to the Nebraska 47-yard line. Smith with time. Flushes out to the left. Overshoots Mazi Albano. Late flag in. Late hit by the Huskers. Number 15 for Nebraska is Alfonso Dennard. And our referee tonight, who will fill us in, is Dennis Lipsky.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness on the 15. Defense. Contact on the defensive player at the 15-yard penalty with an automatic first down.
Alfonso Dennard, Nebraska's preseason All-American cornerback. First game of the season. Just have to be a little smarter than that. Especially on third down, your defense had done a good job, gotten off the field. Now you give Wyoming a new set of downs.
Alfonso playing for the first time this evening, missing the first 3 games after straining his left quad during training camp. Was willing to share with us he's still a little nervous about that left quad. Can't wait to get out there and try it out. See how it feels in game situations. So now first down and 10 for the 39. Smith pumping to his left, running out of time, and there is Damian Stafford from his safety position in to make the sack, loss of 1. Well, Anthony pointed out that you can't hold the ball too long against this defense, and he had some time, saw nothing he likes, and you knew the outcome was going to be he's down for a sack.
Outstanding coverage by Alfonso Dennard and Austin Cassidy. Nowhere to go for the young quarterback. On the far side, same thing. No one's open. Good job by Nebraska of covering up. Justin Blatcher comes in for the dime package. Good job of not giving Brett Smith anywhere to go with him. When you're a freshman quarterback, if that first option isn't open, very few young guys can get to their second and third options.
10th play of this drive. We'll have to wait. It'll be second down and 10. Nebraska leading early, 7-0. Presented by Foster's Australian Root Beer. This is the V-Bar Ranch just up the road from the university here in Laramie. Since we're staying in Cheyenne, we've gotten a good look at all the scenes here. Sean, I know a guy from Florida has, you've at the very least appreciated everything you've seen.
I've enjoyed my stay in Wyoming.
I've enjoyed listening to you enjoy your stay here. Second down 10 from the 39. Brett Smith with time and fires a strike. Chris McNeil would like to have that one back. Siante Evans with the coverage, but that's a drop.
And this is all on Chris McNeil right here. Good job of going vertical with his stem. Great ball location by Brett Smith. You know what really jumps out? Brett Smith doesn't really play like a true freshman. Moves around in the pocket, has thrown the football away when no one's available, has made some very accurate throws thus far in the football game.
Current drive, 10 plays, 42 yards, taking 5 minutes and 13 seconds off the clock. Huskers rush 4. Smith in trouble, buying time, finding Ogbonna. Was he inbounds? No, he was not. Offensive coordinator Greg Brandon told us Friday, hey, Brett Smith can get you out of jail. That's what he does here.
You have to love the freshman quarterback. Just watch him compete. Doesn't give up on the play. Keeps his head downfield. Just a little bit out of bounds. But for a true freshman, a guy that was in high school in Phoenix last year, you have to be impressed by his moxie. It doesn't seem like the moment is bigger than him.
And I'm impressed by the clock in his head, Sean. We talked about how that protection can break down, and he felt it without even having to drop his eyes. Still kept his eyes upfield and looked.
Austin McCoy punting to Tim Marlowe. Marlowe will not get a chance. Wyoming downs it at the 12-yard line. Punt of 27 yards. So where is Laramie, Wyoming? Well, you fly into Denver, Colorado, drive for a couple hours into the state of Wyoming. You'll find it right here. Population, a little over 30,000. War Memorial Stadium right in the heart of Laramie. Elevation of 7,220 feet. That's the highest stadium in Division I football. And altitude can be tough if you're not used to it.
He almost passed out walking from the trucks to the Wyoming facility yesterday.
First down and 10 from the 12. Rex Burkhead, fresh off a 45-yard touchdown run out near another first down. There is a penalty marker down on the 11-yard line. That would be a gain of 9, tackle made by Brian Hendricks.
Only number 58 offense. Half the distance to the goal. Repeat, first down.
Number 58 is the center, Mike Caputo. Penalties per game, a nice improvement from last season, almost 8. And they've cut that nearly in half here in 2011.
And this is not where Nebraska's offense operates at its highest level. And now you see Willis, number 85 in the game at the left end, one of the better pass rushers for Wyoming.
Martinez inside, give to Burkhead. Wyoming defense up for the challenge that time. Inzacha there. Hendricks is there. No gain.
And Paul, they told us about the movement they were going to have to use up front. These big uglies, these Hogs from Nebraska, they can lean on you. But you see that Cowboy front penetrating into the backfield, and they're rallying. When I was at practice the other day, Marty English, I heard him say the word rally 15, 20 times at least.
Second and 15, toss sweep to the right side. Burkhead just putting his head down, fighting his way out to the 12-yard line. Tackle made by Mark Purcell from his nose tackle position. That's a gain of 5.
And whether or not conditioning ends up being an issue as this game moves forward, but that's where Wyoming, talking about that rallying to the football, the swarm that their defensive coordinator Marty English wants to see, that's where they feel like they have the potential to stay in this contest.
Marty English, the defensive coordinator, says we want Taylor Martinez in third and long. Not a great passer. We don't think he reads defenses that well. Cowboys bring 4. Plenty of time. Run it, Tim Marlowe. Wasn't even close. It'll be 4th and 10.
Taylor Martinez is a tremendous athlete, but very unconventional with how he throws the football. If you look at this low release point, very difficult to be consistently accurate throwing the football from that release point. Right there, I think it was more on the receiver, Tim Marlowe, breaking off his route. But it's something if Taylor wants to make that next step and become truly elite that he needs to work on.
Brett Maher back to punt, deep to receive for Wyoming, the freshman wide receiver, Trey Norman. Maher with a beautiful punt. Trey Norman lucky he was standing next to the boundary there. Punt of 57 yards. Wyoming Cowboys hanging in there. Late in the first, Huskers by 7. Welcome back to Laramie, Nebraska on top. 7-0, 1:20 left in the first quarter. Wyoming back with the football. Brett Smith showed very well for himself so far, has avoided the mistake, just like Dave Christensen shared with Anthony Heron, was a priority. Moved the Cowboys in the last drive, but did not come up with any points. Brandon Miller is the running back to Smith's right. Here's Brandon Miller, the former walk-on wide receiver, just across the 30-yard line, gain of 3.
And Paul, there's a really good reason why you're seeing very limited space in the middle of this Nebraska defensive front. It's because of guys like Baker Steinkuhler, big number 55. He's lined up tight on that guard. When you're talking two gap, you want to hit that block, but then get off the block, and that's what allows you. As you see Terrence Moore, zero technique on the center. Center leaves, so he just goes into the backfield and makes a play. It's one thing to two gap, one thing to be able to hit that block and keep him off the backers, but Nebraska's defensive line is in playmaker mode.
Carl Pelini, defensive coordinator for the Huskers, fired up on 2nd and 7. Back to the ground. Fighting to the 33-yard line goes Brett Miller, gain of 2.
And this is tough duty, whether you're talking 0, heavy 5, 2 technique. When you hear the even numbers, that's where you're lined up pretty much head up on an offensive lineman. You got to wrestle with that big ugly across from you. This is tough duty. And Terrence Moore, the senior, he was as excited as anyone I saw just watching Nebraska warm up, because this is his opportunity. He's been a rotator throughout his career. He's getting his chance to make this start. And he's been a guy in the rotation over the years that's made plays for them up front.
15 minutes up here in Laramie, and through one quarter, we have ourselves a ball game. Brett Smith and his Cowboys hanging in there against the 9th-rated Nebraska Cornhuskers. We've played one, and Nebraska leads by 7. Nebraska and Wyoming are both 3-0. However, the Huskers, the only team to score in the first quarter. 7-0 Nebraska. First play of the second quarter, 3rd down and 5, the true freshman quarterback, Brett Smith. Rolling out to his right, little touch pass, just overshooting his intended receiver, Robert Perron, and it's 4th and 5.
And Carl Pelini is being very aggressive. You see Ciante Evans, both corners are right here. They're going to play really aggressive with these Wyoming wide receivers, force them to prove that they can beat man-to-man coverage.
Back to punt for the Cowboys, Austin McCoy. This is Tim Marlowe signaling for the fair catch, caught at the 2nd time. At the 29-yard line, punt of 38 with no return. Let's take a look at our Gillette Fusion ProGlide flashback. In 1994, Wyoming put more than just a little scare into the second-ranked Cornhuskers. Nebraska had to rally from a 21-7 halftime deficit behind late quarterback Brooke Behringer. Lawrence Phillips scored 3 touchdowns as the Huskers came back strong in the second half, avoided the upset with a 42-32 victory. Nebraska going on to win the national championship that season. 7-0 Nebraska, courtesy of a 45-yard touchdown run by Rex Burkhead in the first. And that's Taylor Martinez, high and behind to Kyree Cooper. It'll be 2nd and 10.
And when you're a smaller defensive front dealing with mass, keeping them on the move, I see that affecting the Nebraska offensive line. It's not always penetration, but it's keeping them guessing.
Marqueston Huff with a chance for the pick. Couldn't come up with it, and it's 2nd and 10.
Excellent route by Kyrie Cooper right there. That's a throw that Taylor Martinez has to make.
Taylor Martinez back to the air. Once again behind, and that's Kenny Bell. No flag down. And it'll be third and 10. Top of the broadcast, Sean, we talked about the accuracy issues for Taylor Martinez, yet to have a game over 50%, and that's playing out early.
And this is a seam route by Jamal Hunter. Tremendous route. Former high school quarterback, understands spacing. Taylor Martinez has to throw this ball inside. Luke Ruff is playing about 30 yards deep. If he throws that ball accurate, that's a touchdown.
Jamal Turner, true freshman, played quarterback in high school. Cowboys bring four. Martinez with the pockets. And misses Kenny Bell. Three incompletions. Out comes Nebraska's punt team.
And life as a quarterback with a football team who's got the dominant run game of Nebraska is usually easy in the backfield. You're usually clean in the pocket, but when they get them behind the chains and in these predictable yardage situations, that allows the defensive line from Wyoming to pin their ears back.
Brett Maher, 55 yards per punt. He's hot already tonight. Back deep is Chris McNeil. Low punt. Chance to return. Spins out of trouble. And then goes down. And we also have a penalty flag down on the 24-yard line. 47-yard punt and a return of 8.
Block in the back, number 24 of the receiving team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Number 24 is Kenny Browder, playing for the first time this season tonight. Chris McNeil with a nice move early, then goes down. The Wyoming defense doing its job. We'll see if the offense can follow suit. Versus drops the puck on a new NHL season Thursday, October 6th, with an opening night doubleheader. First, the Flyers visit the defending Stanley Cup champion Bruins. Then the Penguins take on the Canucks. The NHL on Versus Hockey is here. Cowboy offense also here. First down and 10 from the 14. True freshman quarterback Brett Smith just 2 for 8 right now for 18 yards. Cowboy offense averaging 2 yards per play. To the ground, Alvester Alexander with a gap up the middle, fighting for extra yardage. Just past the first down marker, a little bit over 10. Tackle made by P.J. Smith, but that's a first down, Cowboys.
Alvester Alexander is one of a trio of backs, and if you watch at the point of attack, good job of double-teaming the nose, creating a hole for Alvester Alexander. Great job of running through the initial tackle attempt by Austin Cassidy. Dave Christensen is starting to make me a believer. I doubt it seriously if they could run the ball directly at Nebraska, but so far they've had success running the ball right at Nebraska, which is very surprising.
Here's Alexander once again putting that head down. Tackle made by Thad Randall in the gain of 2.
And in talking to the Nebraska staff, they felt like it was about the fits of the linebackers that were kind of throwing off the run game. And Dave Christensen and his staff, they scouted that out. They could tell we may not have a physical mismatch with our offensive line against the Nebraska defensive front, but if we can get a crease with their linebackers, that's our best shot of success.
Greg Brandon also telling us his best players in space, the top three running backs, Miller, Alexander, and Muhammad. That plan plays well into the milking the clock plan, which is what Dave Christensen shared with us. Take time off the clock. Second down, 8 from the 27. Back to the ground, Alexander. Nothing going around that left side. Thad Randall there once again, gain of 2. Chase Rome also in on the action for the Nebraska D.
Paul, they've had some success running the ball directly at Nebraska. But as this game progresses on second down, they're going to have to give Brett Smith an opportunity to complete passes. They don't want to continually stay in 3rd and 5 and more. It's a very difficult situation for this Wyoming offense.
Third down and five if you're Carl Pelini. Do you come after the quarterback or just rush four and see if he can make a good read?
I think you bring pressure. You try and make this young quarterback uncomfortable.
There you go. Huskers bringing that pressure. Smith finding a way out of it, buying time. And Ghali Muhammad with an excellent catch, a gain of eight. Brett Smith buys the time. Ghali Muhammad with the grab, first down Wyoming.
And Paul, this is a tremendous play by Brett Smith. This is Levante David, a player who Carl Pelini said is the best linebacker he's ever coached. To avoid the Nebraska defender, didn't have enough moxie and composure to find Ghali Muhammad. I really like this true freshman.
First down and 10 from the 38. Here's Ghali Muhammad after the first down reception. How about a first down sprint? B.J. Smith with a tackle, a gain of 14 for Wyoming.
Hey, guys, what did they tell us that Ghali Muhammad added to this run game? Toughness.
And watch the edge. He's not going to get any credit for this, but watch Mazi Agbana on the edge on Ciante Evans. When your wide receivers buy into the run game, it makes it incredibly productive when running backs get to that second level and those secondary defenders have Wyoming wide receivers that are attached to them.
Brett Smith and the Cowboy offense now inside of Nebraska territory. This is Brandon Miller around the left side. Austin Cassidy running him out of bounds. Another positive play for that Wyoming run game. Gain of four. A very late flag comes raining in, and it's laying on the 40 or the 38-yard line. Dennis Lipsky getting the infraction. Getting it straight before he shares it with us.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 80 of the offense. Contact on a defenseless player at the 15-yard penalty. It'll be second down after the enforcement. Second down.
Number 80 is Chris McNeil. And he came in there late to B.J. Smith. Real late.
And we met with Chris McNeil yesterday. Actually, a communications major. Would like to get into broadcasting after his Wyoming career is finished. I'm not sure he's big enough to try and be aggressive and violent.
Wyoming right now with 25 plays. Nebraska has run only 12. 26 comes on second and 21. Little quick flip out to Haran. That's how you wrap him up. Lance Thorell with the tackle, loss of two.
You know, Chris has to be very careful in that situation because those safeties, they don't forget those kind of things. And when you're only about 165, 170 pounds like McNeil, at some point during this game, you're going to end up over the middle of the field, and it could be some payback.
Third down, 22. Got a good play call here. If you do, you could have a nice career as an offensive coordinator. You got this down figured out.
I'm going to let you call this one.
Punt is the play call.
But the inside give to Brandon Miller. Puts his head down, approaching the 50-yard line. Big pickup, not enough for the first down. Gain of 10. Tackle made by Austin Cassidy from his safety position.
And Dave Christensen is completely fine with that. I mean, let's be honest, guys. It's 7-0 right now. Getting towards the midpoint of the second quarter, you're again taking time off the clock. They want to slow down the tempo of this game. Completely out of character for Wyoming. But right now, it suits them up to this point.
If I was Wyoming, I'd be very careful about kicking this ball to Amir Abdullah, who's the punt returner, and it's very dangerous for the Nebraska Cornhuskers.
Another flag down. Two flags down.
Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
Well, these are one of those instances in the game when things are going right, your game plan is working. You don't want to give Amir Abdullah a chance to change the momentum of this football game. He is dynamic, he's explosive, and he's extremely fast.
True freshman from Homewood, Alabama. Nice punt by Austin McCoy. a little bit too strong. He didn't give Abdullah a chance to return, but did kick it into the end zone, and the Huskers will begin first and 10 from the 20. Punt of 55 yards. 9:18 left in the second. Nebraska by 7. A little bit of flavor you see there. All Wyoming in the front, cowboy outfits and the horse, and all red behind him. Those seats added, over 3,000 added to accommodate the demand from all the Husker fans coming in to watch their ninth rated team. They're in for a fight against the also 3-0 Wyoming Cowboys. That's Rex Burkhead putting the head down right up the middle.
Coming into the football game, Nebraska quarterback Taylor Martinez only completing 48% of his passes this year. If they want to make the next step, if they want to compete for championships, he has to find a way to be more accurate. If you see, none of these footballs are catchable, and I think it has a lot to do with his release point. It's very difficult to use that sidearm release and be accurate down the football field.
Toss sweep to Green. Josh Bazoom says, how do you do? The reigning Mountain West Conference Defensive Player of the Week. No game.
And Josh Bazoons is a former fullback who's now playing defensive end. Good job of coming down the line of scrimmage. Puts a violent, vicious hit on freshman running back Aaron Green.
Third down and 6 up to this point. Nebraska only converting 1 out of 5. Third down situations, and Taylor Martinez only 2 for 6 tonight. Cowboys bring 5. Martinez with time. Quincy Anunua with the catch and the turn upfield into Cowboy territory. Good catch, good pivot, nice fight, and a gain of 30.
Hey, Paul, they have a lot of talent on the edges. Quincy Anunua is one of those big, fast receivers that they have. If you watch, great route. He runs a deep hook route right here. Good throw by Taylor Martinez. Look at the location. If Taylor can sit in the pocket and accurately move the football, Nebraska becomes very difficult to defend.
Rex Burkhead, left side. Another sprint. Number 22 out to the 24. Tackle made by Luke Anderson. That's a pickup of 22 for number 22.
And this is just the old power sweep. That fullback's coming down the line. Tyler Legate, led by the offensive guard. Hat for a hat, power running football.
Burkhead already with a 45-yard touchdown tonight. The only points of the game. First and 10 from the 24. Martinez accelerates up the middle after riding Burkhead to the left side. Gain of 7. Tackle made by Devin Harris from his linebacker spot.
And one thing that's a big part of Nebraska's rushing attack that we've not seen a lot tonight is Taylor Martinez running the football. Wyoming has really made this Nebraska offense one-dimensional, almost turning them into a passing type of team.
Second down 3. Huskers on the move. Here's Burkhead again to the left side. That's a Husker first down inside the 10-yard line. Tackle made by Tashawn Gibson after a gain of 9.
And this drive almost feels like that third quarter against Washington last week. The momentum wasn't working in Nebraska's favor, and then they challenged the big guys up front. That offensive line just started leaning on the Washington defensive front.
And watch tight end number 25, Kyler Reed. When he's in the ball game, he's not in there as a decoy.
Martinez had Tyler Legate in the flats. Play that worked for a touchdown last week. He chooses to go to the back of the end zone to Ben Cotton, incomplete.
And this is the frustrating part for Nebraska offensive coordinator Tim Beck. This is actually a bad decision. This ball should go in the flat. If you see the fullback, Tyler Legate is by himself. And that frustrates Tim Beck, but he understands Taylor Martinez, only his 16th start. He's going to have patience with his young quarterback.
Second down 8. Martinez, touchdown, Nebraska. Taylor Martinez keeps it himself. 8-yard score. It's 13-0.
And all Taylor is doing is reading that middle linebacker who was Brian Hendricks on that play. If the guard Moore gets up to the linebacker, he keeps that football. If not, he gives it to Rex Burkhead to go around the right tackle.
Rex Burkhead with a 22-yard run to lead that scoring drive. Brett Maher up and in. Taylor Martinez finishing it off with an 8-yard sprint up the middle. 8 plays, 80 yards. 8-yard touchdown for Taylor Martinez, and Nebraska leads by 14. Rex Burkhead has a 45-yard touchdown run moments ago. Taylor Martinez running it in from 8 yards out. A couple of extra points. Ninth-rated Huskers lead 14-0. Sean King, I really feel like the Wyoming Cowboys doing a nice job of hanging in there. But they need this offense to come back, sustain a drive, and get some points on the board.
They definitely need to put some points up. You can see Nebraska is physically bigger and stronger than Wyoming defense, and they're starting to wear down.
Brett Maher kicking. And he's got that group. Anthony Heron, what are you seeing, pal?
Well, there's no doubt about the physical mismatch in this football game, as Sean just referenced. But Wyoming felt like there was an opportunity to scheme and find some creases in the run game, and they've done an excellent job of that so far. We saw Alvester Alexander doing. We saw Brent Smith. He had to move the pocket. He's made timely plays, and they've gotten to the edge of this Nebraska D. But self-inflicted wounds are not the way you stay in a game with the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Chris McNeil, we got to talk to him the other day. He's a thoughtful, insightful young man. Can't have that happen.
First and 10 from the 20. Brent Smith still in the quarterback. The true freshman, Alvester Alexander, is the running back to his right.
And Chris McNeil said himself, this is the first time a lot of these young players have been in a game of this magnitude.
Here's Alexander. Little space around the left side, but that is a perfect form tackle in the open field by the preseason All-American, Alfonso Dennard. Gain of 4.
And that's a big tackle. If he doesn't make that tackle, Alvester Alexander's out the gate.
And you got 3 running backs for Wyoming with 3 completely different styles. And you know Nebraska, they're scouting that field. They know that Alexander is a cutback guy. He likes to come all the way across the field. And that's where you saw Dennard. He's been getting those mental reps, as he told us. He knows what to expect.
Empty backfield. Greg Brandon, offensive coordinator, telling us on Friday in this formation, Brett, find a quick completion. Don't be greedy. There's that quick completion to Chris McNeil to the 29-yard line, gain of 5. Alfonso Dennard once again with the coverage.
And it's interesting. When Wyoming goes to empty backfield, I thought that Bo Pelini would automatically blitz this formation. They played zone to it. Brett Smith did a good job of finding the open guy, which is Chris McNeil.
Third down and 1. Brett Smith huddling up with his Cowboy offense. Now approaching 5 minutes, 30 seconds left in the first half. Smith right now, little under 50% at 5 for 11 and 30 yards. Gives to Alexander, cuts it up. First down, Cowboys. Bounced it out, showed a little patience in a burst. 9-yard gain and a Cowboy first down.
Not only the different tempos, but the different formations. It puts stress on your defense. You saw Eric Martin there in the joker position trying to hit the A-gap, and Alvester Alexander just once again bounces the ball outside, and he's got a nose for where the chains are. I really thought coming in the advantage would go Nebraska's way on the outside. On the exterior, are you able to block? And you don't need to kill people out there, as you know, Sean. You've just got to stop the defender enough so your running back can come up behind you.
Timeout, Nebraska. Second chart.
So Wyoming picks up a first down now inside of 5 minutes. Cowboys on the move, but the Huskers with a 14-point lead. College football on Versus continues next Saturday at 2 o'clock with 4th-ranked Boise. Boise State looks to avenge last year's crushing loss to the Nevada Wolfpack. It's Nevada, Boise State. College football on Versus. Every game means everything, and that game means a whole lot to the top 10 landscape, also the top 5 landscape. There is Brett Smith, true freshman quarterback, not only starting but doing a nice job. Good courage, good decision so far, and his Cowboys are hanging in there. Just as I'm talking him up, misfires to Kali Muhammad. Muhammad wanted.
I've been very impressed with Brett Smith. He was in high school a year ago. The stage is not bigger than him. The young freshman quarterback has competed. If you watch him, he's not afraid. He's running around. He's trying to make plays. He's been the inspiration for this Wyoming offense. I know it hasn't produced points yet, but if you're a veteran on offense, you have to be thoroughly impressed with the way that he's finding a way to create positive plays offensively for this Wyoming team.
And I think we see exactly why his head coach, Dave Christensen, looked at us and told us on Friday his teammates will fight for him. This about 30 minutes after offensive coordinator Greg Brandon said he already has the respect of all of his teammates. And I think we see exactly why with the way he buys time, puts his head down. He's not afraid.
And it's not normal for a freshman quarterback. I played as a true freshman, and I wasn't nearly as composed as Brett Smith.
Empty backfield once again on second down 10. Smith with time to fellow true freshman Josh Doxson. Gain of 7. Corey Cooper on the coverage.
And if I was Brett Smith, anytime I got Corey Cooper matched up in man-to-man coverage, I would go at him. He's a guy that's played safety, trying to make the transition to corner. It's a difficult transition.
And part of that transition is the additional running you have to do when you're playing from the middle of the field. We saw Corey Cooper leave the lineup earlier, had some difficulties on the sideline. They had to get some extra fluids back in him.
Third down and 3, once again, the empty backfield. Once again, Smith gets rid of it quickly. That's Mazie Agbada. Not a big gain, but just enough for a first down. Gain of 5, the Cowboys inside of Nebraska territory, facing first and 10.
And Wyoming likes to be diverse with their formation. Here you see you have 1, 2, and 3 receivers in a trips. All they're going to do is flood this zone. Use it almost as a running play. Try and get a 4 or 5 yard completion. Get in second and manageable, or in that instance, pick up the first down.
And they've been talking on the Wyoming sideline about the aggressiveness of Nebraska's corners. They were trying to get hands on them early. That's why we've now seen them go to some of the bunch looks and the stacked alignments on the outside.
Nebraska defense. Brett Smith, true freshman for Wyoming, and Taylor Martinez, the sophomore quarterback for Nebraska. That's what the numbers tell us. Sean, what have you seen?
And I don't think the numbers tell the true story, especially with Brett Smith. I thought he's played with a lot of moxie. He's ran around. He's made some plays. I think Taylor Martinez, on the other side of that, has to find a way to become more accurate. He's missed some wide open throws. The one drive that he did consistently complete the football, they drove right down the field and scored a touchdown.
You look at that 3 for 8, though, and I brought it up to Tim Beck when we talked to him this week. I said, does it bother you that Taylor Martinez does not complete 50% of his passes? He says, no, as long as he makes big plays. He had the 8-yard touchdown run. He tossed sweeps to Rex Burkhead. This is one quarterback who can get by because of the way this running game works without completing a high percentage of passes.
But I still think it's about efficiency.
It would be nice.
Efficient on offense, you have to be able to complete passes, especially when guys are open.
Can't argue that. Over 50 would always, always be good. First down and 10. Brett Smith now at 50%, 6 out of 12. Mazie Agbada has the catch and room to run. Mazie Agbada, touchdown Cowboys. Smith to Mazie Agbada, and the Cowboys are on the board.
This Nebraska secondary has given up some big plays. It's going to be a simple slant route, but I told you, anytime Corey Cooper gets matched up on man-to-man coverage, if I was Brett Smith, I would go at that wide receiver.
Daniel Sullivan on to cut Nebraska's lead in half. That's exactly what he does, and it's 14-7 Huskers. 3:37 left in the first half.
Paul, they're starting to believe in Laramie. The poise of the true freshman quarterback, Brett Smith, sits in the pocket. Levante David, the best linebacker at Nebraska, is breathing down his throat, makes an accurate, on-time throw. End result, big play, touchdown Wyoming.
I like that you said accurate. We were just talking about accuracy or lack thereof from Taylor Martinez. Nice catch and run by Agbada, but that doesn't happen if Smith doesn't hit him in stride.
and just standing in the pocket, understanding that you're going to get hit, that there is somebody coming right down the barrel. The poise of this true freshman is just unbelievable.
Seven plays, 80 yards. Brett Smith to Mazi Agbana, and Nebraska only leads by seven.
Again, Wyoming has to be very careful. Nebraska does have the number two kick returner in all of college football who's not gotten an opportunity to return the ball yet in Amir Abdullah.
Short kick, trying to avoid Abdullah getting his hands on it. He does in a non-traditional kind of way. Catches it and rolls out of bounds.
I think that's really smart.
Coming up, it's the Geico Halftime Report. Liam McHugh is in our New York studios. He'll be joined by Doug Flutie and Roland Williams. They'll have all the scores and highlights from a very busy day in college football, and they'll preview tomorrow night's game in the National Football League between the Colts and the Steelers. It's the Geico Halftime Report as we are 3 minutes and 35 seconds away from halftime here in Laramie. Husker offense back on the field. Last time they had the football. Touchdown. Here is Rex Burkhead trying to find his way, but the Wyoming defense is there. Ryan Hendricks there to make the stop. Gain of four.
Got the opportunity yesterday to meet with Wyoming linebacker Brian Hendricks. Just fell in love with the kid. You know, really good person. Embraces the opportunity that's presented to them today against Nebraska. His parents came to the game from Colorado, said he really wanted to play well for his father.
Second down, six. Play action to Burkhead. Martinez to an open freshman, Jamal Turner. Cutting, still on his feet. Gets out of bounds. You can see why he was one of the most elusive dual freshman or senior quarterbacks in the nation last year. Gain of 10. Tackle made by Mark Zacha.
And you see that athleticism. That's all that's standing between Nebraska and being an elite offense, is Taylor being able to get those guys the ball.
Empty backfield, four wide receivers to the left. Here's Jamal Turner with the speed and a first down for Nebraska out near midfield. Turner to the right for 10, now to the left for 13.
And this is one of those overload wide receiver screens. Great job at the point of attack by Cal Reed, the tight end. Gets Jamal Turner to that next level. He's a very dynamic player, a player that came in as a quarterback. They were like, he's so athletic, we have to move him so they can get on the field.
Play action, Burkhead, nice job of picking up the bazoom blitz. Martinez flushed out of the pocket, gets rid of it. And it'll be second and 10. Mark Zacha providing the outside the pocket pressure.
And Mark Zacha is a great story. He's quite a long ways from home.
Germany, you think?
Yeah. Got the opportunity to come to the States and pursue his dream of playing collegiate football at the University of Wyoming, and his teammates love him.
Coaches love him too, thrilled with his athleticism. Think he's only going to get better and better as he learns the game. His high school didn't have a football team in Germany. Second down 10. Martinez rolling to his right. That's Kyree Cooper. Did he catch it? No, he didn't. Incomplete.
And Paul, I actually think Taylor throws better on the run. He gets outside, actually makes a really good throw.
Perfect.
Doesn't look like Kyree Cooper maintained control all the way.
Kyree Cooper's second drop of the evening, and it'll bring up second down 10.
But you see how explosive this offense becomes when Taylor pushes the football vertically down the football field.
Third down and 10. Nebraska started this night converting one of their first five third down situations.
There's no delay of game. We delayed in putting the ball in play. Please reset the 25 seconds and start on my whistle.
Bo Pelini taking that news in stride. Just like Dave Christensen, the crowd revved up. Third down and 10. Last two games against Fresno State and Washington. Nebraska offense converting less than 30% of its third down situations. Empty backfield. Just gets it off in time, rolling out to his right. Brandon Kinney with the catch. Will he get the first down? Yes, he will. Martinez to Kinney, a gain of 11. Tackle made by Marcus Zacha.
It's a good job by Taylor of seeing Corey Jones coming off the edge. Understood that he would be unblocked. Moves to his right, makes an accurate throw to Brandon Kinney. Great second effort by the senior wide receiver to pick up the first down.
Right at the two-minute mark, here comes the option. Taylor Martinez putting that head down. Coaches want to see him slide more, but it's always nice to see the quarterback run somebody over and pick up five.
You know how I feel about quarterbacks that call running plays.
You don't like it.
But this is a good job of coming down the line. Doesn't have the pitch man, makes a good decision with the football. And if you notice, he really wrapped the football up. Had an earlier fumble in the game when he didn't have good ball security. You know Tim Beck has been preaching that when they've gone to the sideline.
Runs over Gabe Napton and that beard that he's been growing since Christmas. No timeouts left for the Huskers. And there's a freshman mistake. Kenny Bell, true freshman, wide receiver out of Boulder, Colorado.
And that frustrates both Pelini. Nebraska, because of the spread, doesn't even use a snap count. How can the wide receiver jump off sides? They don't even have a snap count.
Still a manageable situation for the Husker offense. Second and 10 with 1:22 left in a 14-7 lead. Martinez to Burkhead, one-handed catch. And a tackle by Tashawn Gibson in his Wyoming best 41st consecutive start tonight. Loss of four.
Great job by Tashawn Gibson. True freshman, offensive lineman Tyler Moore has a responsibility to get out and block the corner. Tashawn read the screen, supported strong, made a great play.
Now inside a minute, third down and 14. Cowboys bring four. Martinez with time and a strike to Brandon Kinney right in front of Tashawn Gibson. Short of a first down. Gain of 11.
You get one-on-one coverage with Brandon Kinney. Tashawn Gibson's playing a little too soft right there, but does a good job of making the tackle. Doesn't allow Brandon Kinney to pick up the first down.
Brett Maher, 7 for 7. Already this season, this from 50 yards out. He is 1 for 1 from 50 yards out this year. Timeout, Cowboys.
30 seconds.
Let's take a look at the beat, the themes, the storylines we've seen here tonight. Rex Burkhead got us going, or at least he got the Huskers going. 45-yard touchdown run. It was 7-0. Taylor Martinez, not a lot of success yet through the air, but 8-yard touchdown run, and it was 14-0. But Brent Smith had something to say in the form of a perfect strike to Mozzie Agbada. Down the left side, he goes 48-yard score, and it is 14-7. Ninth-rated Huskers leading. But the 3-0 Wyoming Cowboys, much to the delight of the crowd, at least those wearing brown and gold. And Nebraska now with a chance to increase that lead to 10. Brett Maher, once again, 7 for 7 in field goals this year, attempting from 50 yards out.
And Paul, he was making them from 63 in warm-ups, so well within his range.
Brett Maher has his first miss of the season. And Nebraska has only a 7-point lead at halftime.
You couldn't script this any better if you were Dave Christensen and the head coach of Wyoming. This is exactly what he wanted.
In golf terms here, Sean, he needed just a little more draw.
Yep.
Bring it back in. That's pretty close.
That was extremely close.
They thought they had it. They all thought they had it. Anthony Heron has Wyoming head coach Dave Christensen.
Wow is right, coach. And you told us during the week you wanted to completely change your tempo. Looks like that's worked offensively. How do you keep it going?
Well, we got to come out in the second half. We got to continue to do that. We're running between the tackles a little bit, having some success there. But we got to protect, throw the football. We got to tackle much better. We have guys in position, and we're not making plays. And, you know, we just got to eliminate their big plays. Eliminate their big plays, it's a tight ball game.
And we know Nebraska's run game is going to be tough to keep under control. But how do you continue to do what you're doing defensively?
Well, we just got to try to match them physically. You know, they've got depth, and, you know, we're playing eight guys on our defensive line. We just got to try to match their physicalness and keep them out of the end zone.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Paul.
Anthony, thank you. And we are at halftime here at War Memorial Stadium. The Nebraska Cornhuskers leading 14-7 over Wyoming. Stay tuned for the Geico Halftime Report. Let's go to Liam McHugh in our New York studio. We knew we were going to have a beautiful evening here in Laramie. We knew that War Memorial Stadium would be sold out. We didn't know what it would look like at halftime, and it looks awfully good. Nebraska leading only by 7, 14-7 over the Cowboys. Paul Burmeister and Sean King in the booth. Anthony Heron on the sidelines. The Cowboys and the Huskers on the field, ready to get quarter number 3 started. It'll begin with Nebraska. Taking the football, Amir Abdullah. True freshman number 8 would like to have a chance to return. The Cowboys would like to keep it away from him. Set a Nebraska record earlier this season, 211 return yards in one game. That against Fresno State. This is Tim Marlowe. Well, it's not Abdullah, but this is going to be an excellent start for the Nebraska offense at the 45-yard line. Late flag in, 2 late flags in. After Marlowe made his way out to the 45-yard line, 2 flags came in late.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 16 of the kicking team. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, first down.
Number 16, DeAndre Jones, cornerback out of Killeen, Texas.
And that's just not smart. It's after the play. The play's over. DeAndre has to be able to control his emotions. This is a very important drive for this Wyoming defense. They did a good job of taking away the big play from the Nebraska offense. But this is where the attrition starts to rear its ugly head, is in that second half when these big Nebraska blockers become a little too much for the Wyoming defensive line.
Penalty marker down. Rex Burkhead patiently waiting for something to open up. Penalty marker is down as Burkhead runs for 7. The Wyoming Cowboys.
Offside, number 21, defense. 5-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
Let's check in with Anthony Heron.
Paul, as Nebraska came out of the locker room, I spoke to a very calm, cool, and collected Bo Pelini, who said he's happy with the way his defensive front has played without Jared Crick, but feels like in the secondary, where they've made a couple of lineup changes, they have to feel better against the run. Also said that he likes the way his quarterback, Taylor Martinez, has thrown the football, but his offense has shot themselves in the foot as they've approached the red zone.
Has to like that the Cowboys have handed him 23 yards. Nice hit by Josh Bazunes. Senior defensive end for the Cowboys, gain of 2 for Rex Burkhead.
When the Wyoming Cowboys come onto the field, they come by a statue that says Cowboy Tough. This is Cowboy Tough. Josh Bazunes meets Rex Burkhead in a mano a mano, and he says, you know what? Not now, not on my watch.
Rex Burkhead approaching a 100-yard evening with 97 yards, including a 45-yard touchdown run in the first quarter. Second down, 3. Martinez wanted his tight end, Ben Cotton. That's Mark Inzacha batting it down. It'll be 3rd and 3. Wyoming coaches so fired up about the athleticism of Mark Inzacha. We get a little piece of that right there.
And that's a nice feel. Anytime you have a young player who hadn't played a lot of football, Inzacha coming over from Germany, sometimes they don't have a feel for the game. That was a good job of reading the eyes of Taylor Martinez and making a big play for his defense.
3rd down and 3. Nebraska just 2 for 6 third down situations in the first half. Penalty marker down for the 3rd time of this half.
number 73, is the true freshman out of Clearwater, Florida.
Good job by Bazoons of seeing the movement, of forcing the referee to make the call. Tyler Moore is the first true freshman offensive lineman in the history of Nebraska to start.
Nebraska has to get to the 31-yard line to keep this drive moving. Martinez stepping up. There's the acceleration. And there's the slide. And there are one, two, three flags in. Can't hit the quarterback once he goes into that slide.
Isn't that right, Sean Kidd?
That is exactly right. And a bad decision by Luke Anderson.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Number three, defense. Contact on a defensive player. That's a 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Dave Christensen prides himself on having a disciplined ball club. Luke Anderson, once Taylor Martinez starts to make this slide, you can't come in head first. Terrible decision by the safety.
It's the defender in me, guys, but I couldn't disagree more. Luke Anderson had left his feet already by the time Taylor Martinez slid.
There he is with the pitch to Burkhead. He's got something going off the left side. First down, touchdown, Nebraska. Taylor Martinez working the option with Rex Burkhead. 16-yard touchdown, the second score of the night for Rex Burkhead.
This is an outstanding job by everyone. If you see Taylor makes the pitch, the fullback Tyler Legate blocks the edge defender, and the rest is all Rex Burkhead.
Rex Burkhead now over 100 yards, 45-yard touchdown run, 16-yard touchdown run. This coming off an excellent game against Washington when he had his fifth career 100-yard rushing game. Led Nebraska with 120 yards with a career-high 22 attempts. Back-to-back strong outings. Maher knocks it up and in. Penalties from Wyoming and Rex Burkhead on the option. And the Huskers leading 21-7. Didn't take Nebraska long to answer, to respond coming out of that halftime locker room. Taylor Martinez, option pitch to Rex Burkhead, 16-yard score. The Huskers back on top by 14. Burkhead now over 100 yards for the second consecutive game. Taylor Martinez did a couple things there that he's not extremely fond of. He slid once, led to a penalty, and he pitched it on the option.
Look at the output for Burkhead, 115 yards on only 10 carries.
No chance for Ghali Muhammad. It'll be first and 10 from the 20.
And Paul, Dave Christensen told us throughout the week that if you're physically overmatched in a ball game, you have to execute, you have to keep your head. And there's been moments where opportunities have been there for Wyoming where they've lost their head. And it is an electric atmosphere down here on the field. Fan bases from both teams are all over the environment here. But when you shoot yourself in the foot, these self-inflicted wounds at Wyoming has put upon themselves, it's put them behind the eight ball.
And Dave Christensen told Anthony prior to the game, the quarterback, the freshman quarterback, Brett Smith, has to avoid negative plays. He's done a nice job of that. His teammates would like to have some decisions back that led to penalties. Five penalties for 50 yards already for Wyoming. Wyoming beginning with the ground game, and that's a nice way to start for Alvester Alexander. First down Cowboys, gain of 12, tackle made by the defensive end, Cameron Meredith.
And this is just a hat for a hat. They're going to trap the defensive tackle with the guard, create the opening for Alvester Alexander. That gets him to the second level. Coming into the game, Dave Christian said, we're going to run the ball right at Nebraska. So far, they've been really effective.
And it was that wham play they just ran right there. That was where they struggled a bit against Washington last week. Remember, the last two ball games, they've given up 100-yard rushers, and that is really out of character for a black shirt D.
Running game lagging a little behind for Wyoming right now. Nebraska over 8 yards per rush in the first half. Wyoming with four, but that's the second positive play. Second in a row for Wyoming here to start the second half. Gain of 7 for Alvester Alexander. Tackle made by Alfonso Dennard.
And we thought the physical advantage would be with the Nebraska deep front. But if you see, Wyoming is getting movement with that defensive line. If I was Greg Brandon right here, those safeties from Nebraska are starting to get closer and closer to help stop this run. Perfect time for a play action pass, try and take a shot.
Alexander, the leading rusher for Wyoming in the first half, 31 yards, and now already with 20 just in the third quarter on two carries. Just getting the playoff. Brett Smith, true freshman to true freshman. Dominic Rufran for the gain of 5. And a Cowboy first down.
We've got an interesting little chicken or egg situation playing out here, because the physical advantage would normally go to Nebraska. But I got to tell you, looking at it here up close, the altitude could be beginning to play a factor, especially up front for the Nebraska D line. Those blocks, we saw them getting on and off in the first half. You see them sticking and staying on those blocks here early in the third quarter.
You mentioned the altitude, 7,200, 20 feet, the highest stadium in Division I football. Brett Smith now 9 for 16, 1 touchdowns, no picks. Back to Alvester Alexander, and this time that Nebraska defense there, gain is only 1. Highest elevated stadiums in the country, War Memorial Stadium right here, over 7,200 feet. Falcon Stadium in third place. We saw Air Force and TCU from there for the... Now we just need a game at Northern Arizona, Sean. We've done the trifecta. We may just have to drive there and say we've been there.
I learned my lesson last week, though. I did not walk up the stadium steps.
Empty backfield on 2nd and 10. Brett Smith to the left. Complete to Caraway, gain of 3, tackle made by Austin Cassidy, the safety.
And Sean, I'm curious from your standpoint, how long does it take as a young quarterback to develop this clock that Brett Smith seems to already have in his head? He feels if there's any pressure or not. He's hitting that third step, and the ball is gone on time consistently.
I think a lot of the credit has to go to Greg Brandon and the staff at Wyoming. You can tell that he's been coached day in and day out of practice to get rid of the football, get that first option. If it's not there, either get to your second option or tuck the ball and try and get positive yardage.
That completion was to DJ Lester. It's now 3rd down 7. Here comes the blitz. That ball was left behind. Mazia Bonna. Lance Thorell with the coverage, and it's 4th and 7.
And Carl Pelini starting to dial up that pressure a little bit. They played very conservatively on defense in the first half, really sat back. Probably anticipated the true freshman making some mistakes. They see now that they're going to have to create their own chaos defensively, but a lot more aggressive with their defensive play calls on that drive.
Austin McCoy on to punt. Amir Abdullah would love to get his hands on it. 13.1 yards per punt return so far this season. This is a fake, and that's Ghali Muhammad, but that's the Nebraska special teams coming up with a huge play. The gain is only 3, but hats off to Matthew May, the linebacker, who made that stop.
Even though it doesn't work, I love the play call. Dave Christensen is going to be aggressive. He's done a good job of standing to the ball game, but the momentum seems to be switching to Nebraska, 21-7.
There's one moment in every game that changes everything. NFL Turning Points, an all-new weekly series produced by NFL Films, Thursday night, 10 o'clock Eastern on Versus. A turning point provided by the Nebraska special teams moments ago. Wyoming going for the fake punt. Matthew May there to stop it, and the Nebraska offense in business once again for the 2nd consecutive time in the second half. Well, they're right at the 50-yard line. Last time it was inside Wyoming territory. Wide open is Kyler Reed. Even after slowing down for it, almost coming to a stop, has it at the 5-yard line, gain of 45. Taylor Martinez to his tight end, Kyler Reed.
And this is what Nebraska does. They lull you to sleep. They've ran this option down the line of scrimmage multiple times. That safety, Luke Anderson, bites up on the fake. Dynamic tight end, which is unique for Nebraska. They generally throw the football to the tight end. Kyler Reed gets behind the secondary. And on film, Taylor Martinez has this problem when he has guys running open, underthrows them a lot.
Martinez to Burkhead, cutting back. Brian Hendricks wraps him up. Devin Harris also there, gain of 1. Kyler Reed came into this game, Sean, averaging 18 yards per carry, or 18 yards per catch, looking at 45 there.
A
Marty English told us yesterday, we can't let Tyler Reed get behind our linebackers. He left out, we can't let him get behind the entire defense as well.
Easier said than done. Dynamic athlete, fast, athletic. Caught 8 touchdown receptions last year for this Nebraska team, which was a Cornhusker record for a tight end.
Play action to Aaron Green. Tyler Legate covered. Taylor Martinez keeps it himself and just dances out of bounds. After getting inside the 5-yard line, no gain. Luke Ruff running him out of bounds.
And if you're Dave Christensen right now, you'd love nothing more than for Marty English to find a way to keep this Nebraska offense to a field goal.
It was 14-7 at halftime. Nebraska in just a little over 1 minute. Scored with the option. Taylor Martinez pitched to Rex Burkhead. Now it's 3rd down and 3. Timeout called.
Wyoming. First charge. Timeout. Timeout.
Taylor Martinez coming over to the sidelines. There is Bo Pelini. Off to a very good start in his tenure as the Nebraska head coach. A lot of pressure here after everything Bob Devaney and Tom Osborne accomplished. But Bo started out at Iowa after playing safety for Ohio State. Graduate assistant back in 91. Then 9 seasons as an assistant in the NFL. Then moved on to become a coordinator. Very high-level programs. Nebraska, Oklahoma, LSU. Before becoming the head coach at Nebraska. I go back to LSU Pro Day, Sean, in 2007. I was there to watch DeMarcus Russell. Bo was the defensive coordinator. I knew him from my time at Iowa when he was there in 1991. DeMarcus was working out, and in the corner, Bo Pelini just on a treadmill by himself. His name was kind of surfacing out there for head coaching jobs. Walked up to him. Didn't break a sweat, literally. On the treadmill, said, you know what? If it happens, it happens. I love it here. Made great contacts in the NFL. It's going to be fun coaching no matter where I am. A little over a year later, got the head job at Nebraska.
A very good coach, has been successful everywhere he's been.
3rd down and 3, Martinez shotgun formation, and Rex Burkhead, the lone running back behind him. Martinez keeps it himself. Wyoming defense not fooled. Devin Harris there. Gabe Napton there. No game.
And it's feast or famine down here on the goal line. When you're going to move your defensive front because you know you're physically overmatched by the offense, there's an opportunity to maybe create a crease there, but they did an excellent job, and the linebackers filled right where they had to. Defensive front got the penetration, and the backers were right on the spot.
Good play by Devin Harris, but that was a bad read by Taylor Martinez. Rex Burkhead should get that football.
Brett Maher had his first miss of the season in the first half from 50 yards out. No trouble from 20. 8:06 left in the third. The Huskers by 17.
It was a good, hard-fought game like we always have with Nevada.
His kick is on the way, and this one is no good. He missed it again.
That's why you play the game.
Here it comes. It's good. The Boise dream is over.
Going to be a big one next week. Boise and Nevada got a big one right here in Laramie, Nebraska, pulling ahead just a little bit, 24-7. Brett Maher just made a 20-yard field goal, kicking off to the Cowboys with 8:06 remaining in the third quarter. Out of the back of the end zone, Cowboys will begin 1st down and 20. All right, offensive coordinator Greg Brandon telling us yesterday, I want to see what my freshman quarterback Brett Smith does when it goes south. Down 17, I think he means this situation right now.
Yeah, and this is a very important drive for this Wyoming offense. You want to see your players continue to compete, and you want your players to believe that if they can create a few big plays offensively and get some points, they're still in this football game.
First half plan was the running game, trailing by 17. Do you still stick to that, or do you go to the pass a little bit?
They've had some success running between the tackles. I would stay with that, but I would attempt to play action pass and try and get a big play down the field.
See what they do here. 1st down and 10 from the 20-yard line. Brett Smith right now 10 for 18, 99 yards, has not thrown an interception, has 1 touchdown. He is leading rusher Alvester Alexander. This is Brandon Miller off the left side, putting his head down. picking up one. Tackle made by Terrence Moore, who was starting for the injured Jared Crick. That's the preseason All-American Jared Crick. Rick Brandon, offensive coordinator, spent time here as an assistant in Wyoming in the mid to late 80s. Wyoming offense was really rolling there. Recently a head coach at Bowling Green, now coming back to work this spread offense with Dave Christensen in his first year. Brett Smith setting up and has an open receiver. And Mozzie Agbana could not come down with it. Little bit underthrown, but very catchable ball.
And Paul, that's what I meant when I said, I always believe when you're an offensive football team, you do things to set up other things. They've had some success running the football. They play action pass. You get Mozzie Agbana behind the safeties who are trying to help and support. Now, Mozzie has the finish. Great throw by the true freshman quarterback. That's a play that he wants back.
And, guys, the most interesting thing I took from our talk with Chris McNeil was the fact that he realized, and he said all the receivers know, they've got a true freshman quarterback, and there's points in the game where they need to pick him up.
Third down and nine, trying to set up the screen. Brett Smith was rushed. Cameron Meredith sniffs out that screen. Nebraska defense impressive there. And it'll be fourth down and nine.
And Paul, when you look at the scoreboard, you see 24-7. The frustrating thing for Dave Christensen has to be that they've self-destructed in some aspects. Mozzie Agbana drops the deep ball. They've had three personal foul penalties that have given Nebraska better field position. If you're going to pull the upset, if you're going to beat a top 10 team when they're in your backyard, you have to play almost perfect football.
Austin McCoy attempted the fake earlier in the third quarter. This time punts it away to Amir Abdullah, and here he goes. Cowboy special teams wraps him up. Versus drops the puck on a new NHL season Thursday, October 6th, with an opening night doubleheader. First, the Flyers visit the defending Stanley Cup champion Bruins. Then the Penguins take on the Canucks. The NHL on Versus. Hockey is here. Nebraska offense back, already with a touchdown and a field goal in the third quarter. 7:09 left in the third, leading 24-7. Braylon Hurd is your freshman running back, and this is Taylor Martinez keeping it, breaking the tackle of Josh Bazunes, and now being run out of bounds by Marqueston Huff, right at the mark, little less than 10 yards, we'll call it 9 on the game.
And I know it's easier said than done, but you have to wrap up a dynamic runner like Taylor Martinez. Josh Bazunes gets an opportunity to make the tackle. Would have been a difficult tackle, but once he gets outside of that pocket, he's so dynamic and he's so fast, you don't want him making big plays with his feet.
20 missed tackles already. Ball's on the ground, but the Huskers able to get back on it. True freshman running back Braylon Hurd.
Good job by Gabe Napton of getting his hand on the football. Even better job by Braylon Hurd of not allowing that to turn into a Nebraska turnover.
Third down and one. There's the old Nebraska I formation. Working the option is Martinez. Hendricks with the tackle for the Cowboys, but that's a gain of four and a Husker first down.
And when the Wyoming defense came to the sidelines, Gabe Napton, he was the guy that was the ringleader. He was the one telling all his teammates to believe. He used a few expletives in there as well as you tend to hear on a football sideline. But as this Nebraska offense continues to just matriculate the ball and lean on that defense, you wonder if even Gabe Napton, will he continue to believe?
Anthony Heron getting in touch with his inner Coach Stram, matriculating the ball down the field. First and 10, looking deep. Deshaun Gibson, nice tight coverage as Martinez with the pass intended for Brandon Kinney. It'll be second down 10. Bopolini telling us that last week against Washington, Taylor Martinez as in command as he has ever been running this offense. That was his 15th start last week. Bopolini gaining a real comfort level, confidence level in his sophomore quarterback. Certainly looks in command here tonight with his team leading by 17. Not so much there. Ball on the ground. Dives on it before Mark and Zacha could get it.
And Bo Pelini is in a unique situation, Paul. He has a top 10 team, but he has inexperience everywhere, in the defensive secondary, inexperience on the offensive line, inexperience at the quarterback position. Difficult task for him to find a balance between being too frustrated and having to exhibit patience with this young football team.
Well, the second half so far has been all Nebraska. The Wyoming defense with a chance to get some of that momentum back with a stop here on third down and 16. Cowboys bring four. Martinez with time, doesn't see what he likes, just dumps it off to Abdullah. Tashawn Gibson with the tackle. And Gibson with the recovery. The most experienced Cowboy, 41st consecutive start tonight with the tackle and the recovered fumble.
And that Nebraska offense put the football on the ground four times during that drive alone. We're very fortunate to recover the first three, not so fortunate on the fourth. Great job by the senior from Texas, Tashawn Gibson, of coming up and putting his helmet right on the football. And that freshman running back, Amir Abdullah, will learn. Sometimes you have to channel your inner LeGarrette Blunt. LeGarrette Blunt has become known for jumping over those defenders to try and go low.
And it was only a three-man rush, guys, but it began with the defensive front. You saw Taylor Martinez wanting to escape for a moment, but Josh Bazoons, Kurt Taufa-Ausau, they didn't allow him. They collapsed the pocket in a way where it didn't give him the running lane.
Alvester Alexander. This is the reverse, and the Cowboys have a first down. Robert Horan. Staying in bounds, we do have a penalty marker down on the 37-yard line.
And this is going to be on freshman Dominique Rufran for a block in the back. Wyoming continues to self-destruct and negate any momentum that they try to build.
There is no foul or a push in the back. He's going to play. First down.
21-yard gain on the reverse. Robert Horan.
And watch the quarterback by freshman quarterback. Watch the block by freshman quarterback Brent Smith. You have to love this kid. This kid is really competing tonight. He's running around. He's showing moxie. He's making plays. He hadn't lost any confidence. And is even willing to be a lead blocker on the reverse.
This drive started with a turnover caused by Tashawn Gibson. Wyoming's 10th turnover it's created in the last three games. Brett Smith with time. And that's going to be pass interference on Nebraska against Lance Thorell, the defensive back. Trey Norman, the intended receiver.
Pass interference, number 23, defense.
And this is a great job. All young quarterbacks that are watching this, Brett Smith gives his wide receiver an opportunity to catch the football. Doesn't overthrow it, doesn't throw it out of bounds. More than likely, it's going to be a completion, or if the defender does not turn around like Thorell did, you'll get a pass interference.
First red zone appearance for the Wyoming offense tonight. 12 touchdowns, or 11 touchdowns in 16 trips inside the red zone so far this year. Nebraska defense.
And if you're Wyoming, you need a touchdown here. You can't settle for a field goal if you're trying to come back and win this football game. If I was Greg Brandon, I'd get a little aggressive here because you have to come away with 7 points from this drive.
Alvester Alexander there with a gain of one. Clock ticking now with 3:45 left in the third quarter with the Huskers on top by 17. This is Alexander again, up the middle, then back out to the outside. Nebraska defense right there. Baker Steinkuhler there for the stop, gain of one.
Alvester Alexander has to resist the urge to get greedy. He's a guy, as we've talked about, he likes to bounce it outside, likes to cut it back. Should have just pressed the hole there on that ball carry and taken his profit.
Third down and eight situation facing the true freshman quarterback, Brett Smith. Has three wide receivers to his left. and one to his right.
And Brett Smith has a man-on-man on the slot with a linebacker. His wide receiver, Robert Herron. I wouldn't be surprised if he looks that way.
Did look for Herron. Fired way out of the back of the end zone. Herron not open. Nebraska defense, tight coverage, and it's fourth down and eight.
And it ended up being a zone coverage. Austin Cassidy is over the top. And the young quarterback will know if he throws this football over to this pylon, and Robert Herron has an opportunity to make that play.
So Daniel Sullivan from 32 yards out with a chance to cut the lead to 24-10. One for two on field goals so far this season. And he pulled that one. He's now one for three field goal attempts this year, and the lead remains 17-4 Nebraska. Good drive for Dave Christensen's group. No points, 24-7. Nebraska hanging on to a 24-7 lead, 2:46 left here at War Memorial Stadium. Sold out and then some, Sean King. Not just the regular 29,000, extra 3,000 plus added for all the Husker fans. Lots of red mixed in with the brown and gold.
The atmosphere has been truly electric, and Wyoming has had their opportunities tonight, have not been able to take advantage of them so far.
Nebraska offense back out of the field. It was 14-7 at halftime. Touchdown and a field goal. It's now 24-7. Tyler Legate over the right side. Tackle made by Josh Bazunes, former walk-on. Three starting offensive linemen this evening also entered the program as walk-on. Starting safety Austin Cassidy started as a walk-on. Brett Maher, punter and kicker, former walk-on. The theme continues here with the Huskers.
Great tradition at Nebraska. You know, kids grow up in Nebraska, around that state. They grow up loving the Cornhuskers. Some of them turned down
scholarships. We have Taylor Martinez now split out as a wide receiver. And Rex Burkhead working the option himself, keeps it. First down, still on his feet. And Rex Burkhead played quarterback for an instant, then morphed right back into his I-back self for a gain of 28 yards.
And Martinez is down here. I actually like his stance.
And he just stays out of the way and lets Rex Burkhead, already with over 100 yards tonight. Great tackles. More than 20 missed tackles already for Wyoming tonight. There's Burkhead just putting that head down.
And you know, Paul, I like this by Bo Pelini and his staff, because you're up 17. You still feel like you need to execute offensively, but you don't want Taylor Martinez to take a bunch of shots late in this ball game with your Big Ten conference schedule starting next week.
Second down, four. Approaching the 1 minute mark of the third quarter. This is Braylon Hurd, two freshman running back. Good burst on that toss around to the left side. Brian Hendricks there with the tackle. Gain of five. There is youth all over the place, pretty much every position on this Nebraska offense. Offensive line, three seniors and one junior in the two deep, the rest freshmen and sophomores. Learning on the job and learning well as this Nebraska run game beginning to take over. That's Braylon Hurd. Gain of seven. Tackle made by Gabe Napton.
And Paul, defensively, this is the difficult part of playing a team like Nebraska, and Anthony can attest to this. You've done a great job defending their run throughout the ball game, but those guys are still 6'4", 6'5", 300 pounds, and you're starting to get exhausted of getting off those blocks.
Second down, three. Martinez with the pitch, and that is an excellent tackle by Tashawn Gibson. The freshman running back, Braylon Hurd, gain of one.
And the point you made there, Sean, is why a quarterback in an offense like this tends to be in a really advantageous situation throwing the football. And Taylor Martinez, we've seen him be up and down a bit passing the football. Last week against the worst pass defense in college football, Washington, he was 10 out of 21. So going in to that Big Ten conference schedule you mentioned, he needs to be more consistent as a passer.
Anthony Martinez also with 10 completions tonight. He's 10 out of 19 for 147 yards. But the leader for the Huskers so far, Rex Burkhead, 13 carries, 150 yards, and two touchdowns. We head to the fourth, the ninth-rated Nebraska Cornhuskers leading by 17. Quarter left here at War Memorial Stadium, 24-7-3-3. Nebraska facing third down and one. I-back formation. Tyler Legate, the fullback, and Rex Burkhead, the I-back. Taylor Martinez keeps it. Boy, he had Legate fighting to hang on to the ball. Couldn't do so. Are they calling that a catch? Because the ball certainly came out at the end.
And again, it comes back to accuracy with Taylor Martinez.
It is a completion there, Sean, and a Nebraska first down.
Legate makes a tremendous catch. But as a former quarterback, and Taylor Martinez will attest to this, if asked, you have to make this throw easy on the fullback. He's in the flat. He's open. He's by himself.
So that play is being reviewed. Did Tyler Legate make that catch? Sean, your initial impression is catch, no catch?
I think it's a catch. He had control of the football, took two steps, and actually lost control of the football after that. If the ball would have stayed in bounds, I think it would have been ruled a fumble.
Well, the replay booth takes another look at the what was called a catch by Tyler Legate on the field. Certainly had it for a couple of steps, but did it come out there at the end? Certainly came out. But did it come out too soon? Bit of an ugly completion from Martinez to Legate. The Huskers will take it because it's good for a first down.
Paul, once he makes that catch, has control of the football, and takes these two steps, now he becomes a live ball carrier. If the ball would have stayed in bounds and Wyoming would have recovered it, it would have been ruled a fumble.
I'm going to correct myself there a little bit. It was an ugly pass. It was a heck of a catch.
Great catch
by Legate. And that's Burkhead once again keeping it. Doing a little bit of everything tonight. That's a gain of 8, tackle made by Devin Harris.
How fun is it to watch Rex Burkhead carry the football? And he's not the biggest I-back Nebraska's ever had. I mean, they've had big bruisers like Dan Alexander, Roy Helu Jr., just drafted last year. But he's got one gear when he gets the ball in his hands.
Also has two touchdowns tonight, Anthony, and 14 carries for 149 yards. Here is carry number 15. Inside the 10-yard line, a first-down making machine. Rex Burkhead has become, that's a gain of 11, run out of bounds by Kenny Browder.
And Gabe Napton, one of the best defensive linemen for Wyoming, had a shot at a tackle for loss. Rex Burkhead stiff arms him, Walter Payton style.
You know, this is a problem here, Wyoming. Gabe Napton, who's your defensive tackle, is about the same size as Rex Burkhead.
First and goal from the 8. Martinez wants the pass, and that's Kenny Bale, true freshman. Touchdown, Huskers.
And this is the maturation you want to see from Taylor Martinez. Kenny Bell is going to be his third option. He gets all the way to his third option and makes a nice, accurate throw right between the 8 and the 0.
Kenny Bell from Boulder, Colorado, said, hey, I love the Buffaloes. Grew up a Buff fan, still am, but Nebraska is just playing better. And that's why I wanted to be a Cornhusker. 13:55 left, and it is now 31-7. Taylor Martinez has a touchdown on the ground, now has a touchdown pass to his freshman wideout, Kenny Bell, and the Huskers have a 24-point lead. College Football on Versus is presented by Foster's Australian for Beer. Sean King, doesn't it seem like on every campus there's a library that's not book-focused, a little more social-focused?
I could have used one of those networks last night.
Maybe a couple, huh? Serving up all kinds of things that we would like to eat, but probably should not. We drove right by the library there. It is
right behind the stadium, behind the stands that they put up for all the Nebraska fans. Created 3,000 plus to accommodate the demand, and we are at 32,617, third largest in Wyoming history. Maher knocks it out of the end zone again. Brent Smith and the Cowboy offense set up shop at the first and 10 of the 20, trailing 31-7.
And we've talked about the miscues, the self-inflicted wounds throughout the night for Wyoming, and penalties have been a big part of it. And then the catches, the drops from the wide receivers. Missed field goal opportunity to try to maintain some momentum and keep yourself in this ball game. Opportunities have been here, and I'm telling you, down here at crowd level, people have thought that there was a possibility Wyoming could come back in this game.
In addition to those miscues, Anthony, 24 missed tackles by that Cowboy defense.
Greg Brandon hadn't stopped coaching, though. If you see the alignment, three wide receivers stacked up, he understands that it's 31-7. That is what it is. But this is an opportunity for his offense to get more reps. They're very young. Get these young players some more opportunities to execute what it's going to help them be successful as they move into the Mountain West Conference part of their schedule.
Dave Christensen sees B. Smith on the back of a number 16 jersey for his quarterback. He brings back good memories from Brad Smith, quarterback for him at Missouri. Then Chase Daniel, he expects a lot out of this offense based off of what he did at Missouri. Second down and six. Brett Smith with time, doesn't like what he has, rolling to his left. Levante David with an athletic play, almost with the pick. But that's an incomplete pass, and it'll be third and six.
I still like the fact that the young quarterback is competing and no one's available. He's running to his left. He's still trying to make plays. Actually, an unbelievably accurate ball for a right-handed quarterback rolling to his left under duress.
Yeah, Smith snuck that in there a little bit better than I thought he did.
And he's another guy that has a unique throwing motion, but unlike Taylor Martinez, he seems to be extremely accurate throwing the football.
On third and six, Smith to Rufran. First down, Wyoming. Out to the 43-yard line. Tackle made by the safety, Damian Stafford. Gain of 19 from Smith to Rufran.
When you're talking about the maturation process of a quarterback, it's about staring down the barrel, like Brett Smith did on that last ball, and still being able to deliver a strike to a wide receiver when he's open. He took a vicious shot on that last pass, guys.
First down and 10 from the 44. Brandon Miller, the running back, to Smith's right. Miller with it, trying to work his way through that Nebraska front. Austin Cassidy up from his safety spot, and the gain is four.
And I know they don't like calling design quarterback runs, but if Brett Smith keeps one of these, this weak side end is crashing down trying to help tackle the tailback. He could run for probably 20 yards before he gets touched.
Second down, six. The Cowboys have not abandoned the run at all, trailing by 24. Dave Christensen told us yesterday that's where the attack would begin. Offensive coordinator Greg Brandon saying we have to run the ball, although this is a pass, and that's Brett Smith with plenty of time. And that's just a drop pass by T.J. Smith, the tight end.
Good defensive play by Damian Stafford, a JUCO transfer. They came over to Nebraska this year. Carl Pelini is really high on him, thinks he's very good in coverage, so much so that when they go to nickel, as opposed to bringing in a new corner, they bring Damian Stafford from safety and allow him to play the nickel back position.
Brett Smith only sacked once, but knocked down six times.
The offensive line from Wyoming has done a good job. Nebraska's not been able to get a lot of pass pressure with their front four.
Third and six, touchbacks to Robert Herron. Does a nice job of hauling that one in. That's a first down, Cowboys, and a gain of 10. Damian Stafford with the coverage. The Cowboys
great
now inside Nebraska
Herron
territory.
Running a little corner route. And I don't really like the spacing by Wyoming, but good job by Brett Smith of being able to go under, over the underneath defender, but in front of Damian Stafford.
Gain Galdi Muhammad, the tailback, going first to 10. Smith, low snap, fields it. Dominic Roof ran. Gain of two.
Very encouraged by the decision-making from Brett Smith. Most young quarterbacks right now will be taking unnecessary chances. He's still running the offense. He's taking what the defense gives him. He understands that this is a small step in the bigger picture for this Wyoming football team.
What do you like best about Brett Smith so far?
Just his composure. Nothing rattles him. He's looked down the gun barrel, made throws, has been accurate. A lot of potential. Sky's the limit for this young player.
Empty backfield on second and eight. Pounded the ball to DJ Lester. Gain of four.
And, Paul, you learn a lot about a young man when you get to just look at him up close like I've been able to do from down here on the Wyoming sidelines. Haven't seen him throwing helmets. Haven't seen him, you know, showing any kinds of negative energy to his teammates. And believe me, there's some situations, as we've shown with the miscues and his wide receivers dropping passes, where he could have done that. But he hasn't shown that at all, and that's a big part of the reason why his teammates respect him so much. And as you referenced, Greg Brandon told us, they knew immediately with the way his teammates responded to him that that's why he's now the starter.
Third down and four. Smith right now 14 out of 27. And he's now 15 out of 28. He gained a five. T.J. Smith with the reception. And that'll be a Wyoming first down. And, Sean, one of the comments you hear a lot from coaches now is the game's not too big for him. I think that certainly applies to a true freshman quarterback going up against the ninth-ranked team in the country, acting like he belongs.
And I think that's such an integral part of playing the position is being able to handle the moments, keep your emotions in check. And he exhibits all of those qualities.
Inside of 10 minutes, now first and 10. That's another strike. Robert Huron, first down reception, gain of 16, and this Wyoming offense on the move, trailing 31-7.
And this Wyoming offense, they lost a two-year starter to transfer over the offseason. Quarterback was supposed to be a position of question. But I believe is what we're seeing tonight, the growth of Brett Smith. I believe there's no way you can call quarterback a question at this point.
That was my favorite pass of the night, just pounding it right on it. Velocity and accuracy, first down and 10 from the 15. Inside give, Alexander fighting for extra yardage. Gain of four. Tackle made by Lance Thorell.
And you look at Bo Pelini, he's frustrated. He's trying to figure out, he came into Laramie, Wyoming with the number nine team in the country. Why his defense can't close out the game? He'll definitely use this game film as coaching point as they move into next week's game versus Wisconsin.
Defense playing well so far, only giving up 7 points, but allowed 74 points in the first three games. Didn't hit that mark until mid-October last year. Brett Smith with time again. And Dominic Roofran can't come down with it. Wanted the flag, won't get it. And it'll be third down and five.
Now that's an important observation that Sean just made, because we saw last week as Nebraska faced Washington, it looked like they had established control of that football game, but they couldn't close out the Huskies. Washington scored multiple touchdowns in the fourth quarter to keep themselves in that contest. A couple of questionable penalties on special teams. Who knows where that game could have ended up?
Brett Smith now facing third down and five. Been a very good drive for him so far. 6 out of 9 for 57 yards. Working the fade. Doxson with a heck of a catch. Was he in bounds? No, he was not. Using all that 6'4 frame and nice amount of skill to come up with that one, but did so out of bounds.
And Josh Doxson makes a tremendous catch. And I can't see from that angle when he actually gets control of the football, but I might want to review this one.
Every play is reviewed. And that's going to be close.
Difficult from that angle to tell if the knee came down on the line or not.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. That play is under further review.
And the question mark will
be, where did his knees come down? Because his knees hit first from that angle. Are they inbounds or out of bounds? Either way, it's a tremendous effort by Josh Doctson.
No question about that, about maintaining the football. He had that.
You see right here, what, this left knee and right knee, is it in or out of bounds?
What do you say?
I think we'll get a better view from this angle.
And I think the toe is going to be the definitive part about it.
Does the toe touch before the knee?
Precisely. That right toe looks like it may be tapping down.
And the toe did touch before the knee hit.
This may be touchdown Wyoming.
And Doctson, from the second he had that ball, from the second he touched it, he maintained possession.
And in live action from down here at field level, it looked like there was no chance
that he could catch up with that football. Yeah.
But that 6'4 frame, and you talked about the effort to extend the body and the strength of the hands, the fingertips are what brought that football in.
Doctson, true freshman out of Mansfield, Texas. Had one catch coming into tonight. Is this a catch? Has the football, that right foot does appear to be down.
And it's got to be, with the call on the field being an incompletion, it has to be indisputable video evidence for the call on the field to be overturned.
Such a great effort. It makes you wonder why Josh Doctson hadn't got some earlier opportunities in this football game to make some plays.
And there's two freshmen. You know, the freshman quarterback throwing to his freshman wide receiver. I mean, there are so many positive signs here for this Wyoming offense when you look at a game like this against the opponent they're matched with.
Dennis Lipsky, the referee, communicating or listening to the replay booth. And there's what they're looking at. Has the football, is the right foot in?
And I guess the question is this definitive evidence that the toe actually touches the end zone? Because it looks like it from that vantage point.
The further review, the ruling on the field stands. Incomplete pass.
The right knee was out.
And it's one of those plays, I think if they would have called it a touchdown on the field, it would have been very difficult to take it away. Fourth the fact down. That it was called incomplete, I think, was ultimately made the decision.
Fourth down and five. Wyoming 0 for 1, fourth down tonight, 2 for 8 on the season. And Nebraska calling a timeout. Dave Christensen facing fourth down and five, his team trailing 31-7. And yesterday, we sat in his office, he looked at us, and he said, hey, no matter what happens here today, I think my team can compete with every team in the Mountain West Conference after Boise, after TCU, based off what you've seen tonight. Do you believe it?
I think he has a good feel for his team. Everything starts with the quarterback. Brett Smith has shown up tonight. The moment has not been bigger than him. And this is a building block that I think can springboard this Wyoming Cowboy team to being a legitimate contender in the Mountain West Conference.
There's improvement all across the board. We're seeing it tonight against the nation's ninth-ranked team. We saw it leading up to this game. The offense, scoring offense, up 17 points per game this year. Total offense up over 200 yards per game. Of course, that's only through three games. But reason to believe in this young Cowboy team. Right now, it's fourth and five, empty backfield for Brett Smith. Huskers bring five. Levante David almost got there, but that's Robert Huron, number six, with six for the Cowboys.
And Robert Huron is going to be matched up with the safety, Austin Cassidy. Great route, mismatch, advantage Wyoming. Even more impressive was the fact that Brett Smith saw Levante David blitzing down the gap and still made an accurate throw under duress, under pressure.
recognize the man pressure. Heads off to the protection for protecting against the that fifth extra rusher. Levante David not there quite in time. Brett Smith, the anticipation and the accuracy. And Nebraska's lead cut to 17. True freshman quarterback Brett Smith now 17 out of 32 for 166 yards and two touchdowns moments ago. On fourth down, the touchdown strike to Robert Huron. There he is. Nebraska still in control, though, at 31-14. You put Taylor Martinez back in the game, Sean?
I think so. I don't think Bo Pelini is satisfied with how his ball club has played today, even though they got the win. I think he still feels like his offense can execute better than they have tonight.
And that win still 8 minutes and 13 seconds away. Nebraska 31, Wyoming 14. Ball sails over the head of Tim Marlowe. And Huskers will have first and 10 from the 20-yard line.
And Paul, from Bob Devaney to Tom Osborne and now to Bo Pelini, the lifeblood of the Cornhusker program has been physicality at the running back position. And while Rex Burkhead, he may only be 210 pounds, but he certainly brings some thump with him when he's running the ball. And my favorite thing about him is that his dance card is full. He's not looking to shake anyone in the open field. He wants to run through people.
Not Burkhead, that's Amir Abdullah, untouched for a first down so far. Made a name for himself on special teams through three games. 24 yards on that run.
Amir Abdullah is one of a trio of freshman running backs here at Nebraska. Braylon Hurd and Aaron Green being the other two who they are extremely excited about.
That was his first rush of the night. This is his second. Mike Purcell puts the first hit on him, but that's a gain of 9, and that Nebraska running game has it going. Tigers offered Amir Abdullah as a safety. He said, no, I'll play running back for the Huskers. There's Rex Burkhead playing the best running back tonight. 170 yards, 11.3 yards per carry. This is Green, another freshman running back. Aaron Green. Devin Harris with the tackle.
And right now, Nebraska is getting in a traditional I formation, and they are running power sweep. They're getting a hat for a hat. Bo Pelini's trying to prove a point right now.
Aaron Green with a rush of 11 yards. Follows that up with another nice gain. Pick up a 7 yards. Tackle made by Mark Willis. And 2 when going over 200 yards tonight. 71 yards over 200 already. Marty English, defensive coordinator for Wyoming, saying we got to stop the run. And that's Braylon Hurd. Have him wrapped up, but he has another Nebraska first down. Hendricks with the tackle. Huskers pick up 6.
And the thing that I'm struck with, especially getting to watch the Nebraska O-line in person, is the versatility of the group. They're not just the ground and pound type that needs you right there in front of them. When they run a zone play, they can get up to the next level. When they run a gap scheme, they can double team you and sit you 15 yards downfield.
Aaron Green just putting his head down. Hendricks there again. It's to the 18-yard line, gain of 4.
And you get the sense that that's where Tim Beck wants to be able to take advantage of the group he has up front. We've talked about the rotation throughout the night. They bring the different big uglies off the bench, put them on the field, and it looks like no one else. There's no drop-off at any position, but the offense itself needs to be able to execute the versatility at the skill spot.
Amir Abdullah back in the game around the right side. Out to the 15-yard line, gain of 3. Marty English told us one of the many things he shared with us on Friday, that priority number one was stopping Taylor Martinez. They've done a nice job of that. 11 carries for only 32 yards, less than 3 yards a pop. But Rex Burkhead, 170 yards rushing at over 11 yards per carry. There is Marty English, coaches the linebackers, coordinates the defense for Dave Christensen. Here's a chance to tackle Taylor Martinez. He looked a little hesitant there, wanted to pitch it, didn't like the fit with his running back there. Picks up 6 yards and another first down.
You know, Paul, you say didn't like the fit. Amir Abdullah was nowhere to be found.
he turned and looked for him. He was not there.
He looked to pitch to Abdullah, and he wasn't there. It actually ended up working out well for this Nebraska offense as Taylor was able to pick up the first down.
Maybe a freshman Taylor Martinez would have pitched that. It was a senior I met him. Braylon Hurd tossed sweep to the right side. Willis with the tackle down at the 7-yard line. Gain of 3.
And this drive has to be very exhausting for this Wyoming defense. When they're running that power toss, that's a lot of running. I mean, you, as a linebacker, you have to scrape all the way from one side of the field and then they run it to the other side of the field. The exhaustion level on defense for Wyoming has to be high.
Second down goal, another sweep to the left side. Braylon Hurd down to the 2-yard line. Willis again with the tackle, gain of 5. See Mark Willis making a lot of tackles from behind here after about a 5 or 6 yard gain on this drive.
And not only is Nebraska making this Wyoming defense run side to side, their tempo is still at the pace it was at the beginning of the game. They're not wasting any time.
11th play of the drive coming. Braylon Hurd, touchdown Huskers. Braylon Hurd, Cardinal Mooney High. Bo Pelini likes to see all of his Huskers play well, but maybe even a little bit more when went to the same high school he did.
Carl and Bo Pelini went to Cardinal Mooney. Also, offensive coordinator Tim Beck.
Brett Maher on to make it 38-14. Now inside of 4 minutes left in Laramie. The ninth-ranked team in the country, Bo Pelini's Nebraska Cornhuskers, taking back control of this one now, leading 38-14. Next Saturday on the Mountain, Mountain West football kicks off at 2 p.m. when San Jose State heads to Fort Collins to battle Colorado State. And at 6 o'clock, coverage moves to Albuquerque when New Mexico plays host to New Mexico State. Spartans Rams at 2, Aggies Lobos at 6. Next Saturday, only on the Mountain. Nebraska run game continuing to roll. Braylon Hurd punching it in. And Nebraska 43 carries for 299 yards. That's 7 yards per rush. Coming into this game, the Wyoming defense giving up only an average of 3.2 yards per carry. Quite a difference taken on the Huskers. That was Dominic Rufran, true freshman wide receiver. There he is from his own goal line. Tackle made at the 21 by P.J. Smith. Bo Pelini may be thinking just a little bit about what's going to happen next Saturday. Huge game, not only the Big Ten, but nationally. Might be the biggest game in the country at Camp Randall Stadium against the Ohio State Buckeyes. An evening kick, or I'm sorry, against the Wisconsin Badgers coming back to play against Ohio State. Bo Pelini in 1991 was a GA at Iowa when Brett Bielema, head coach at Wisconsin, was a junior nose tackle for the Iowa Hawkeyes. That relationship goes back a ways. Brandon Miller to the 22-yard line. So the Huskers have the Badgers and the Buckeyes coming up. How about the Wyoming Cowboys? One more out-of-conference game at Utah State before kicking off the Mountain West Conference schedule against UNLV, then a bye week, and then it's all Mountain West Conference opponents.
Coming off of a 3-win season last year here in Laramie, you can see the improvement in this ball club. Dave Christensen is excited about the direction the program is headed in and feels like they're close.
Interception, P.J. Smith.
Really the first mistake of the game by true freshman quarterback Brett Smith. had Dominique Rufrin open across the middle of the field and just threw the football a little high. The football sailed on him just a little bit.
High and behind will get you in trouble every time.
Especially in the middle of the field. Good job by Nebraska safety P.J. Smith of going down and catching the football. That will excite Bo Pelini.
Nebraska never lost a game under Bo Pelini when scoring at least 35 points. 19-0. Breon Carnes, backup quarterback in for the Huskers as Taylor Martinez takes a rest.
Breon Carnes is actually from down in my neck of the woods, Paul. Attended Bradenton Manatee High School, which another pretty good player at the University of Nebraska. Played quarterback, wore number 15, Tommy Frazier. That was also his high school.
Gave the defense fits last year running the scout team. Working that option awfully well as the Nebraska run game continues to dominate in this second half. Tackle made by Marqueston Huff.
How about that pitch? Bradenton Manatee employs a pure option attack. You can see the comfort level. Breon Carnes comes in off the bench, and you can just tell the option is something that he's ran his entire life.
Austin Jones, the eye back now for Nebraska. Rushing yards at 300. Austin Jones again up the middle. This is the second week in a row the Huskers have gone over 300. They hit 309 in the victory over Washington at home last week. That tackle made by Brian Hendricks.
You know, Paul, they just overwhelm you. You know, they play 7-8 offensive linemen. Those guys stay fresh. They have 3-4 legitimate running backs. Those guys stay fresh, and they just wear you down.
Leaping inside the 5-yard line. Austin Jones carrying the mail here on this drive. Tackle made by Marqueston Huff. Husker ground game, though, has been unstoppable for this Cowboys defense as the game has gone on. Rex Burkhead leading the way. 16 carries, 191 yards, 2 touchdowns. 45-yard touchdown run, also a 16-yard score. Rushing yards right now, 335 for Nebraska. And they're going to go ahead and take a knee. Head back to Lincoln. Get ready for the Wisconsin Badgers next weekend in Madison with a 4-0 record and a 38-14 win over Wyoming.
And, Paul, I think that was a sure respect from Bo Pelini to Dave Christensen. Pelini recognizes the job that the Wyoming Cowboys did today, how they competed. He respects that.
Yeah, clearly Wyoming not in the class right now of Nebraska, but I think just as many positives as negatives for Dave Christensen's group. Bo Pelini jog out for the handshake. Cowboys fall to 3-1. Huskers improve to 4-0. Bo Pelini going to put this victory behind him and concentrate on the Badgers and then the Buckeyes the next week. Our Anthony Heron is standing by with Husker head coach Bo Pelini.
Well, Bo, from the outside looking in, a lot of people expected you guys to just walk through this Cowboy football team. How do you feel like you guys performed tonight?
No, we'll take a look at the film. I thought we did a lot of good things. I thought we did some things that we need to get cleaned up. And like any other week, that's not a bad football team. I think that Coach Christensen's doing a good job with that program, and they've made a lot of strides. And we knew coming up here for the first time on the road, it wasn't going to be just a walkthrough. It's a decent football team with some pride.
And Jared Crick not playing in tonight's game. We know about your depth that you have on the defensive line. losing him, did that affect what you guys did up front?
Anytime you take a guy like that out of the football game, it's going to affect you. But I thought our guys stepped in, played well, and now it's time to move on to Big Ten play. We got a lot of, take a look at the film, and we'll get fixed what needs fixed and move on.
And, of course, everyone looks at what Taylor Martinez does in the game so closely. How do you feel like he's continuing to grow?
I think he's growing. I think he's doing obviously there's some things I think he could have done better out there, but I thought he played a good football game, and I'm glad he's on our team.
Thanks a lot, Bo.
Thank you.
Anthony, Bo, thank you very much. Sean King, what impressed you the most about the Huskers' 38-14 victory?
The way they really closed out the football game. They came in to Laramie feeling like they had a size and strength advantage. They really committed to running the football. Rex Burkhead had an outstanding football game, and I think those last two drives were very impressive for the Cornhuskers.
You mentioned Rex Burkhead. He carries 15 times for 170 yards and two touchdowns, coming from 45 and 16 yards out. Nebraska Cornhuskers heading to Madison, Wisconsin with a 4-0 record. Right now ranked 9. We'll see if they move up in the top 10. That's it from War Memorial Stadium in Laramie, Wyoming. Nebraska 38, Wyoming 14. We'll go to Liam McHugh in our New York studio after these messages.